here's your feel good story of the day. It's feel good story Monday.
Feel good Monday.
Yeah,
we only feel good story Monday.
We only do this once a week.
No, then we make people feel like crap.
Your mother wakes up to find her cat's head just outside her window.
Wait.
Wait, wow.
How could this be feel good story? Unless it's peeking in, sniffing, going, "Let me in, mommy. I'm cold."
Well, the cat's head out the window. This could be a feel-good story.
Yeah, give it time, man.
All right.
Maybe the cat would sneak into the baby crib at night and chew its face.
Steal its breath.
Don't be such a negative Nancy.
Oh, I was going to go with Ned.
Yeah, I know.
Your mother wakes up to find her cat's head just outside her window.
It would take a cat's head off. I mean, that's pretty sick. Not to mention throw it back at the family's yard.
Soon Yi, an 11-year-old calico, was found beheaded 2 weeks ago. A day later, another family cat disappeared. As Heather Brown tells us, the family is speaking up because they don't want this to happen to anyone else. Oh.
They can tell there's an absence, definitely.
They've been very needy, kind of. They want a lot of attention, and you can just tell that they know something's wrong.
One in their family of five is missing. Another is dead.
I just think it's kind of sick.
Found by her owner in their backyard.
We get a morning sun from the east side. She just pulled up the blind. The remainder of the cat was off to the right of the boat. No other hair, evidence, limbs, nothing. Just a perfect, straight, severed head.
Sounds like El Cata. Must be those Muslims.
How's our caddy?
There you go. This is the awful people in this world.
How do you do that to a little cat?
Can't do that to a cat.
The whole time.
Oh. Little cat. Don't hurt cats. You pet them. You scratch them under their chin, and they shut their eyes, and their chin goes out, and they go.
No, you declaw them, and you position them carefully on your stomach, so when they do that little push thing with their paws, you face them away from you, and they do the little push, and it's just rather lovely. Push.
Poor cat.
Terrible.
All right, we'll...
El Cata.
We'll take a break and continue in just a minute.
Right.
We got your ridiculous story of the day, and then, of course, your feel-good story of the day.
Oh, good.
Ridiculous first.
And a man in New Hampshire went out on a limb, you might say, to pull off a bank robbery. Mm-hmm. Take a look. Police say the man disguised himself as a tree. They say he used duct tape to attach branches to his head and his body. Cops say he did not use a weapon when he demanded cash from the teller. No word on how much was stolen. The suspect is still on the loose.
This could be gravy. Don't worry, it's just a harmless little bush.
What an idiot. Maybe not an idiot. He got away with it. They're still trying to find the tree guy.
He disguised himself as a tree. All right, and robbed the bank.
And he walked in the bank as a tree?
Surprised Billy Joel didn't drive into him.
Another Billy Joel joke. Funny.
All right, he made it out. Good for him.
Yeah. Dressed as a tree, so make your tree jokes at home. They made the good one with the limb.
He went out on a limb.
Yeah, that was a good
one.
I
get it.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
I think Buffalo might have story of the day.
Yeah.
Buffalo might have the story of the day. Although, this is what was written for me, so please don't get all mad at me. Retard sings national anthem at Fenway Park, gets nervous, and what do you think the crowd did? And when I read the story, I'm like, Boston? Oh, my God. They must have started booing and throwing stuff.
That's what I thought, booed.
But Boston behaved, and the crowd helped the little fella out.
Aw, Boston. Out. That's adorable.
Actually,
he was the mayor.
Huh? Now I got to play it. Very good. Now I got to play this because we referred to it. And then we'll get to the Buffalo story, which could be story of the day.
We have the audio, obviously.
Of Fenway? I do believe we do, yes.
Now, is this, any background on this crooner, this young crooner?
Yeah.
Besides being mentally challenged, handicapable. Slow? What type of mental retardation were we looking at here? Can you tell?
Hold on. Here we go.
Is it the old DS?
What does he got there?
No, he didn't have didn't have that.
None of the downs?
Yeah, it was just a regular one, I guess.
Like just regular.
Oh, my God. Sorry to interrupt, and I don't even know how I say this on the air, but maybe we could put this video up on our website. Ken in Jersey from Point Pleasant. This morning on Channel 7 News, that would be here in New York, around 6:39, the anchor called Hillary Clinton. Hillary...
Right. See,
how about this? Wait. How about this? I got it. How about this? Take out the L-I and add a U.
She called,
done.
She called her what she is.
Yeah. Done.
Wow.
It would be like
done.
It would be like calling Bill Clinton Bill Presidentin.
See if that's true, Danny. And then the co-anchor commented that there would be a meeting about it later today. I got a good laugh out of it. Maybe something you guys could use.
Wow. Where is that? Pull that audio.
So Danny's trying to find out if it's true. Here's the Fenway audio. Oh, we were going to get the answer from Danny. What did he say? He just ran out to do another job.
He said just a normal one.
Slow guy.
Like, slow guy.
All right.
Can you see by the dawn's early light?
Why would they do this?
Oh, my God.
Why would they do this? I understand you want, you know, people to feel good and be involved and be lead normal lives like that, but you're just setting setting up. You don't know which way this is going to go. As an organizer, they're saying this is a great idea. You don't know which way this is going to go. This could have been tragic if the fans in Boston were half as scummy as they usually are.
Do you understand that Michael Bolton had to write the lyrics down? Michael Bolton,
yes.
He sings a lot in front of people.
Yeah.
A couple things. Mike in Boston, I am so glad Mike is saying this today. He's a hardcore Red Sox fan. He writes, Opie, Fenway Park no longer represents Boston. It's more of a social hangout now than it is for Sox fans. It's a bunch of chicks in pink hats and families. Guy nailed it. Last time I went to a Red Sox game, I'm like, what's up with all the pink freaking Red Sox hats?
Well, once
they started that trend up there.
Glad you won the series, because that's what it's all about, my friends. That's what happens when they win the series. It's all over. Now you get all the other Johnny-come-lately fans and their chicks and the pink hats and all that stuff goes along with being the champs.
Right, right.
Glad you finally did it.
They started that trend, and now every ballpark in America has the females wearing the pink hat.
Oh, my God. He does look like him.
He looks like what?
Oh, jeez. Look at the video.
I noticed they couldn't find a hat for the little fella. You make your own joke at home.
Nah, you see a wading pool with two Red Sox nailed to it here, stupid. Put this on.
You get home from the Red Sox game, and your wife's like, or girlfriend goes, well, I didn't know it was a doubleheader today. No, it wasn't a doubleheader. It took an hour to get the game going.
Oh, no, she just meant the size of his skull. And you know what? We'll get yelled at for making fun of him, yet we didn't put him in front of 60,000 people.
Exactly.
What are we saying?
What are we supposed to do?
Of course.
It was a water header.
All right, so far so good with this guy.
A little off key, but
by the way, the video's up on our website.
Well, bottom of the seventh, the Red Sox are downs.
So far so good.
What the hell was that?
Wait a minute.
Start laughing?
I see a woman signing next to him. Is he retarded or is he deaf?
He wouldn't be deaf.
No, maybe...
She can't sign like that, and he's staying kind of with the, you know...
Maybe they want the deaf to enjoy, too.
Maybe. Yeah, that's probably it.
Oh. What?
What's up, Than? No?
What, Than? What do you got? What happened? What happened?
Dan had some insight.
It's Disability Awareness Day, so...
Oh, okay.
You needed somebody to sign for those that are hearing disabled.
How about wheeling a guy up in a wheelchair that can sing?
Exactly.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Yeah, exactly. Get some crippled crooner and let him belt it out.
Right.
How disabled do they want to get? How about a guy with no mouth? Let him blow it out through his nasal passages.
have amputees play the basses for the day.
Yeah, with the drums.
That old gag.
play the drums with your stumps.
Uh-oh, what happened?
People love giggling retards. They just love them.
All right, hold on. Cigars and scotch.
Now they've encouraged them.
Yeah, cigars and scotch. What's up?
Hey, he made it all about himself. Booze, broad tongue, and not so bright stars.
Oh,
look, I'm sorry. Now. I'm sorry for that. I was only joking.
Who's broad tongue?
Oh.
Oh, did you see that jerk? Here's your feel-good story of the day. Feel-good Monday. The crowd helps the little fella out. That's right.
I don't think they're helping him out. I think they're upset that he's making a mockery of the song.
And they want the game to begin.
And they want the game to begin. They don't want this, you know, kid to make it all about himself because he got a laugh by going, and then he decided he was going to do it the whole goddamn song. You ever do something like stupid kids running around the house and you throw a ball or something at them like you do with a dog or whatever, and they think you got to play with them for like 10 hours? That's what he was doing. He chuckled and everyone laughed. And then he's just going to do it all day. So those people were not helping him out. They wanted the game to start.
I think they were helping.
No.
I think they were just, that he realized he was fluffing.
I have faith in my buddies in Boston.
Spinning in a circle and drooling. They're like, let's just help this person.
I think Boston finally showed they have a heart.
Oh.
They finally showed it.
The grounds crew had to remove the tarp from underneath him where he was drooling.
Let me tell you something, Boston. I have to say this today. If this was happening in Philly, it would be a whole different ending, man.
Oof.
Wow. I don't think they'd be singing along and helping the little fella out.
Cut the top of his head open and pour the marbles that pop out down some stairs.
By the way, this is too good. Snap Man from Whack Bag. For Disability Awareness Day, did the Red Sox play the Yankees? Take it.
Come on. Okay. Ten games. Bum, 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 bum.
This sucks.
Oh, come on, man.
That was not a happy moment. They just wanted the game to start.
I got to be completely honest with you.
Yeah.
This is Greg Hughes, the actor that will be on the Opie and Anthem
honored.
Show. I would probably... Oh, man, I'm...
What?
I'm getting ready to be thrown under the bus, but that's fine.
Get a little.
I would probably have a little teary eyeballs happening there if I watched that. Yeah.
Yeah.
For some reason, I gotta admit it.
The same look the family came out when the
right.
Family had when the doctor walked in.
I think I'd be a little teary eyeballed at that one.
And said, "So you like to drink, do you, ma'am?"
Obviously.
Yeah, I think I would have been taken by that one.
I got some good news. You could spend that college money any way you like.
Yeah. New Jaguar vacation? For dad.
Remember that vacation you were avoiding because of college?
Go ahead.
Enjoy. I'll go enjoy Italy. No, I think I'd be affected by that. I got to admit it.
Really?
Yeah, I think so.
Why? If they were all
getting a little emotional?
No, all of a sudden the whole crowd tries to help the little fella out. I think I'm going to be affected by that. I hate to admit it, but it's time to start admitting
that
I got emotions.
It's fine.
Why am I feeling these emotions?
Jesus.
I don't know. You're
why? What's going on?
You're right.
What the hell's going on? All right, getting to the story out of Buffalo. It could be the story of the day. I love this one.
In New York, police say that an amputee was attacked by a group of men who took his prosthetic leg and beat him with it. Officials say the four attackers then drove over 43-year-old Richard Kelly while he was lying on the ground.
And they arrested Kelly the attacker, 64-year-old Paul McCartney.
There it is. I hate you, by the way.
Why?
We've brought it up many times. I'm a big Starbucks guy. I can't go into Starbucks anymore. That's
oh, I know. That's
that stupid CD cover.
Dude, every time I see it, I laugh and just think of Jimmy's face doing the Paul McCartney new album pose.
Pursy-lipped tranny he looks like.
Well, he does. He purses his lips. He's got them pursed, and he's holding his lapels, and it's tilted slightly sideways. It's awful.
Oh, here we go.
Here it is.
Come on, everybody.
Here come some good lyrics.
Oh. Playing that ukulele.
Shut up.
Used to be a man.
Everybody gonna dance tonight.
Are they?
You know, everybody gonna feel I need the video right. Where he's walking everybody around the house looking for dancers.
What is that?
Everybody
gonna dance around.
Okay. Dance around.
Everybody gonna hit the ground.
Hit the ground.
Everybody we would just start dance dancing. Around
tonight. But that's what his wife would do. Dance around and hit the ground.
That's what, Paul. Most people can't dance around. We're too busy working two jobs. Maybe you had the time to just walk around your house and dance and play the ukulele.
This is catchy, but lyrically it's childlike.
Be all right.
Dude, if any other musician in the world put this out, we wouldn't be listening to this. That's the difference.
Like, you do snap to it, but it's just enragingly horribly written. Everyone's gonna dance around. That's like a 14-year-old boy sentiment. Well, you
can come the guy that wrote Yesterday?
No, Lennon Fry wrote that.
Did he?
No.
No, that was Paul McCartney.
Yeah, Paul did the Yesterday.
Yeah.
Greatest song ever, though, is Imagine. Sorry, yeah. Paul.
No, I think If My Life is better.
No.
Yeah?
No.
Yeah.
No.
I like Yellow Submarine.
No. There he is with his ukulele. There's ghosts all over the house.
Anything Ringo wrote.
What are you trying to say? All right.
Well, I had a thing I wanted to mention.
Oh, no.
Well, we're still talking about the amputee guy. We just went off on a little tangent. No, we're back on the highway now. Let's go.
It tied in with music.
I'm trying to figure out what this guy did that these guys were so angry.
But yeah. He beat somebody with his prosthetic leg.
In New York, police say that an amputee was attacked by a group of men who took his prosthetic leg and beat him with
it. Can we guess what he did?
Yeah.
Let's guess what he did.
All right.
I say he was stealing rye bread inside of his stump leg. Like he had stacked bread inside of his leg and, no.
And he wanted to return it.
I would have went with pudding.
Oh, pudding. Wanted to return it, and everybody was cool with it until they realized how much it stunk.
It was all mushed in. It was like 30 pieces of bread with like a big dent kind of going through all of them because of his weight. All right, that's going nowhere.
Didn't we have a girl come in with a stump once? And she took her leg off.
And we had sex with her, yeah.
And it just looked really, like, smelt bad.
I don't remember.
Yeah. You need, like, stump deodorant. Yeah. Do they have that? Like, speed stick stump?
You know, Ant and I were talking about our book, Jimmy. We're way out. I mean, the book to get is Jim Norton's Happy Ending.
Of course.
Maybe this time next year it'll be our book. But
yes.
Anthony and I were talking. We're going to have a whole chapter on the vagina.
Good.
And what we've done with it on our show.
Yeah. It's just amazing.
We start remembering all this
science
stuff.
The science that's gone into it.
Like, can we say it now or are they going to dump out? Just like, I'll just say egg shooter, phone, smoking. We had a whole list.
Bottle rocket.
It's going to be just a whole chapter on that. That's going to be just one chapter.
Money,
sure. Mm-hmm.
Beating with it.
Painting.
Officials say the four attackers then drove over 43-year-old Richard Kelly while he was lying on the ground. Kelly has broken ribs and a punctured lung. He was taken to Erie County Medical Center in stable condition. Police say they have no suspects or motive in that case.
This guy had to do something.
There had to be some kind of problem between the people there.
He had a beef with someone.
You don't just pull off someone's leg and beat him with it unless you are really pissed at him for something. Beautiful.
Where's
Let's do a retard thing, though.
Yeah, man. Do they have any audio of the girls?
I want to hear that.
Every night, women walk Valley streets to turn tricks for money.
Nice.
But this man is charged with something hard to stomach, pimping out two disabled women.
That is disgusting.
One at least 18 years old, the other 27, but with the mental capacity of a 15-year-old girl. Police say both walked away from a Valley care facility and met Dwayne Conchola in the middle of May. Police say Conchola forced them to turn tricks, and police say they did. Both of them. We reached Conchola in jail by phone.
I never pimped both girls on the street. My cousin introduced me to the girls. My sister did their hair. We watched a couple movies and that was it.
What? What? Was that the retard talking?
Wow.
Or the pimp?
All kidding aside, what the fuck?
I don't know who that was talking.
That was the pimp.
The pimp?
What did he say? Seriously.
From a Valley care facility and met Dwayne Conchola in the middle of May. Police say Conchola forced them to turn tricks.
Listen close.
Police say they did. Both of them. We reached Conchola in jail by phone.
I never pimped both girls on the street. My cousin introduced me to the girls.
I never pimped those girls on the street. My cousin introduced me to those girls.
Get out of here. You heard that?
Yeah, I never pimped those girls on the street. My cousin introduced me to those girls.
Yeah, yeah, I heard that.
My sister did their hair, watched a couple of movies, and that was it.
You guys are...
I heard it too the second time.
No way.
Easy stuff.
That's right. Sister did their hair.
See, when you
watch,
live...
you put a bowl over it and just go snip, 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 snip.
See, Jimmy and I live among the homies. Here in New York City.
That's true. I'm in wonderful suburbia.
You pick up a little of the language, just walking the mean streets.
That's right, the mean streets of the Upper West Side.
You get me a Jew that you can't understand,
baby.
I'll decipher
UWS.
It.
That's right, out of my way, bitches with poodles.
That's right.
Out of my way, old white lady.
That's right.
With the stretched out skin from the facelifts.
That's right.
They love them up there.
From the front, they look real young. And on the back, it looks like she has a fucking flesh tourniquet tied around her head.
You better watch out, you Botox bitches.
That's
Jimmy
right.
Jimmy and I are walking the street.
Move it, Asian eyes.
That's right.
Even though you're white.
They like shave off their eyebrows and everything and just pencil everything in. They didn't know lips left anymore. They pencil those in or collagen them, so they got the duck bill. The duckbill old woman puss.
You want more on this?
How could you not? You pull up. I'd like a blow job. All right, maybe I wouldn't.
You know you're going to get plenty of spit. Make it feel good.
It's funny. A half and half. That's when you get a blow job and confused questions about cookies.
According to documents obtained by ABC 15, one or both of the victims told police Conchola
for... Man, when you work for a station called ABC 15...
Yeah, you better work hard.
Shouldn't those ABC stations be in the single digits?
Yeah.
I know, maybe a little too inside, but ABC 15 is a little...
You can work hard to move yourself up in the cities.
According to documents obtained by ABC 15, one or both of the victims told police Conchola forced them to prostitute themselves. Hmm. He denies it.
That was my first. Nobody, nothing, wanted nothing. Why still here understanding why they would do that? Like, why would they even say that?
So does Conchola say the girls are lying? Who knows? But he says the only thing he can think of is that he insulted one of the girls physically. This is what he said to his cousin.
I told him, like, you know, my cousin, she's like, why? And I told her, because I'm going to be real. I'm like... He's not my type, and I made him leave.
And it's worth mentioning that both girls are fine tonight in area care facilities. As for Conchola, he faces two counts of pandering, and he's expected to be in court.
Well, she wasn't a very good prostitute. She misunderstood the instructions, where she had to go out and have sex and then give the pimp all the candy.
What the fuck?
She hands him a bunch of pocket lint.
I love our assholes. Man, I love them. Ryan from St. Louis. Opie, you have a great personality, and people like you for your great smile.
Aw.
Here's something positive. The results of a test Jimmy took recently. Brian from St. Louis. Opie, you're somebody. Jimmy, your weak chin makes people feel safe. Are these positive enough, Opie? LOL. So what do you think of that story? Is he lying?
No, of course he is.
You hear him?
Yeah.
I don't know. That probably happens all the time. Probably easy to prostitute out.
RoboCop has something more on this.
RoboCop?
The RoboCop?
Looking for me.
All right. Thank you.
Click. We get nothing out of them.
Old Clickeroony. All right. Now we got USA Today's top ads of all time or Big A post-surgery interview?
I want to hear Big A because I heard he was doing some things. I heard he was doing some things.
Yeah.
Like he's going to replace me or something.
Yeah?
That's what I heard. That's what I heard. He's a fast healer, isn't he?
Dude,
did you see the scar on his neck from his tumor? Wasn't all pussy or anything.
And like I said on the stage Saturday night, it's amazing. He told me during breakfast yesterday that the tumor was... And you always have to say the
during
tumor...
During breakfast?
Yeah. If you have a tumor, you always have to tell people the tumor was the size of a...
And they're always the same types of things depending on the size. There is a golf ball.
Grapefruit?
A grapefruit. What's in between? A baseball.
Baseball?
Like that. Yeah, it was the size of a golf ball, baseball, grapefruit.
I think he said... What the fuck you say? Handball or something.
A handball?
Big A, what'd you say?
Pong ball?
No, it was big. A lot bigger than they thought.
Yeah.
And the weird thing is they take this massive thing out of his neck and he still has a huge pelican
big
pelican
fucking
neck.
Pelican neck. That's what they took out. A fucking fish.
Yeah. It's a rotted salmon.
All right. Billy from Jersey. This cannot be true. He's got to be doing this for
yes, it is.
Billy, go ahead.
Hey, I called for a prostitute once, and they brought me this retarded girl. All she could say was, you can tip me, but don't insult me. So I'd say, well, you want to do it doggy style? And she'd say, you could tip me, but don't insult me.
It's the three-part joke. Come on.
No, it was weird.
Go ahead.
Hello?
Finish.
Finish. Well, I couldn't finish. She was so fucking retarded, I couldn't come.
And then the last time she said, you could tip me, but don't insult me. And then you said, gadunk.
That was it.
Sorry, it was being set up like a three-part joke. But apparently it was a non-story with no humor to it.
There's some other things we want to do today.
Was there?
Top commercials of all time. Pretty interesting list.
Oh!
We got some Big A audio from Ron Fez.
I hear he was doing, like, impressions.
Save this for this side of the show. A compliment box in Washington, D.C. Mm-hmm. Gives you compliments as you walk by.
Oh, I thought you complimented boxes as they walked by.
Compliment
nice snatch. Box. Looks fat. Too meaty.
Do they have it at XM? You walk by and it goes, you're not getting fired.
We should do a bit.
Compliment box?
Oh, yeah. We should do our own compliment box.
Absolutely.
People are walking by.
You look wonderful.
Why aren't we in the other place?
Because they don't build things fast.
We could have a whole thing. The boxes sit outside the studio, and then people walk by, and we give them our own version of compliments.
Yeah, what we consider compliments.
Yeah. See, they got to rebuild our studio immediately so we can get back over to that joint.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
No.
Down there in Washington, D.C., you're walking along.
I liked the Harry Potter names.
Oh, we're going back to that.
Well, I hope we do.
There's some writing going on as we speak. You could be walking down the sidewalk, I guess, in Washington, D.C., and all of a sudden a voice comes out of nowhere and it compliments you.
Usually a voice comes out of nowhere and conks you over the head.
Yeah,
and
there you go.
So where's your money?
Here's the story.
Wonderful city.
Yeah.
You stand out in a crowd.
Walking this street in downtown Washington, D.C. is leaving some local residents blushing.
It said people are drawn to your personality.
Walk by again, and some say this box may even inspire a little pep in your step.
That box should be everywhere, really. It should be downtown.
Most people agree with you.
See that? See? Most people agree with you.
It's been coined the compliment machine, randomly doling out kind words to anyone willing to lend an ear.
I've had my moments when I'm like, just turn it off. But overall, no, I enjoy it. One of my customers came in and said, it told me I smell good. I know I don't. I just finished jogging. He was streaming sweat. So, yeah, people are having fun with it.
Are they having fun with it?
You're white.
What are you doing in this neighborhood? I would leave if I was you.
Goddamn rich cunt.
I set all that up for the other side, see? I was going to beep it. Then I realized where I was.
Yeah.
The machine is part of a larger, temporary art exhibit called Sites Project DC. The technology is simple. Inside is an MP3 player with more than 100 pre-recorded compliments playing every few minutes.
You inspire others.
It's really just to explore, I guess, the idea of compliments, how people give them, how people receive them, kind of like a fortune cookie kind of idea.
God almighty.
You get it and you're like, oh yeah, okay, I am generous.
While the machine is about as accurate as a fortune cookie, Greaves hopes its kind words will make anyone feel special.
Maybe the city likes the idea and they make these compliment boxes and they put them all around the city. And then other cities might do it, or, you know, around the region. And just kind of as like a public service.
Might
no,
do
I
it?
Don't think I'm going to believe the box on the street.
You really know how to take a compliment.
Might do it? No, we will do it. We'll do our own version of this.
He said, I can smell your cunt.
They should ask people after they walk by the compliment box, did this actually make you feel better? Anyone who says yes should just be put against the wall and shot.
Should be zapped.
This is a giant cock.
Those are great.
Someone is suggesting that they should have Steve voice these compliment boxes.
Oh.
You're a woman. You stink. You have something called a vagina that I have no interest in.
Yeah, Steve doing him.
Cock meat. Nothing but cock meat. And it just has to get racist. It's amazing. You should see the ones coming in.
Your pussy doesn't quite smell like fish.
Thank you?
Toast lettering.
This is the dumbest idea. It's like this phony, feel-good waste of time and money and effort. What the hell is that going to do for anybody? You can't say you believe it because it's all random. Could be the worst despicable guy that just raped somebody walking past this thing.
Right.
You're a wonderful person.
I know, motherfucker. That's right. Oh. Jesus.
Some just pedophile walking.
Yeah, some creep.
Still has blood on his hands.
You're a great person. You work well with others.
Yeah, I do. Maybe I should tell him where the body's hidden. That'll get me inspired.
Oh, boy. You know, Les makes a good observation here on the phones. Les, the trucker. Les, what's up?
Yeah, A-O-N-A and Jimmy. They took Jimmy's tender sentiment idea and made that comment box. You know that, right?
Tender sentiments.
Right,
that's right.
This is the tender sentiment thing when you're, feeling down on yourself.
I like a compliment box.
Yeah.
Sorry. Thank you, Les.
Hey, are you about a size 14?
Would you?
All right.
What?
All right. I want the boys in the O&A lab to make our version of the compliment box. How are we going to do it? Are we going to use an MP3 player that randomly does? No, we have to do it live.
I would jerk off to you.
Oh. Why, thank you.
Oh, God. Can you imagine if we could reprogram that MP3?
Oh.
In that box?
Oh.
Why aren't we at the other side? We could be doing this bit today.
You have cranky ass.
They aren't all winners, kids. Okay.
Right.
High fly ball. It leaves the left center field. It's way back. It may be playable. Can't get a play. It's gone. A home run. Oh, he caught it. He caught it at the wall. I thought sure he was unable to reach it.
Yeah, I thought for sure. Yeah.
All right.
Well, it's a dumb idea.
Hmm?
It's a dumb idea.
What?
I dub it a dumb idea.
Why would you do that?
It's phony.
Yeah.
It's more of that phony, feel-good, fake shit.
All right,
Stop it.
We have a quickie from D.C. as well.
Ooh.
Got a fine anchor team from NBC4 in D.C., and they can't stop laughing at a video of a model falling down.
Oh, I saw this.
This is hilarious.
Saw this on YouTube.
Yeah, the video is really funny, but the audio is just as good. So yeah. They're showing a video clip of a model falling down, and the anchor's just can't get enough.
She falls twice.
Yeah.
And the second time she falls, the reason they're laughing so hard, and I started cracking up, her legs are wobbling like a newborn foal, and she's trying to keep herself up, and then she just loses it and falls on the floor again. So they just keep playing it over and over again and just laughing their asses off.
This is Fashion Week over in Paris. The latest fashions are on the runway for next spring. But there was a problem out there today. One of the British designers' shows had the difficulty. A model fell down twice. That's her going down once. The young woman wearing that pink skirt and the orange platform shoes never quite recovered after that. There she goes again. That had to hurt. That was uncool. That's embarrassing. This is at least the second time.
Well, you all are just really tickled by that, aren't you? You try walking in those shoes.
Hey, first of all, baby, I got enough meat on me that it's all right.
George. I'm sorry.
Come on. We want to apologize.
Hold on.
That was great about that. He's got that that smoking laugh.
Oh, yeah.
The smoker's laugh, man. That's great.
And he was ready to say something like, yeah, we want to apologize. And the guy goes, wait, hold it, watch, because it was coming again.
Yeah, yeah.
They kept playing it over and over.
How many times did she fall?
Like twice.
She fell twice, but they kept playing the clip over and over again. Her legs give out on her and start shaking, and these guys just lose their minds laughing.
Where's the other one? I only show her falling once.
Oh, they keep going back to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch.
She falls. Look at the legs. That is great.
Oh, she said wobble.
She
can't
she stand wobbled on those shoes. She almost made it. She wobbled like three times.
They just keep playing it, too.
Oh,
and
she took quite a tumble. Just,
dummy, have a sandwich, you stupid ass.
Damn funny.
Guys, it's losing it.
That's the most respect I've had for the news.
Oh, absolutely.
Wouldn't that be funny if it was a drunk driving story? It ended in tragedy.
You know, that probably would be really good to take that clip of them laughing that hard and put some horribly tragic news behind it.
Can we get on that?
Yeah, can we try that?
We'll let our guys get to it.
Yeah.
We have some very talented people that use various video editing equipment.
Hey, that's a great idea. Trying to see what we got in front of us.
Take them laughing and then just put some horrific...
Man charged with pimping disabled women. He said he didn't pimp them. The victims told police...
Did they?
Sorry.
You have hair like Mo Howard from the Three Stooges. Your tongue is fat.
Big hands. We're going to big hands in a while. Can you print up some missing feedback? I don't want to forget about big hands.
You have a fat tongue.
All right, we'll see what happens.
Talk.
Now we got to play the story.
God hates you.
Now we got to play the story. Now I wish I had the smoker's laugh. For this story.
Rocks aren't candy.
Can you... Your family crops you out of photographs. Your mother drank during pregnancy.
That's rough. By the way, can I interrupt everybody, please? When...
A hanger would have solved a lot of problems.
Yes. You'll have to be cared for until you're 50.
Then you'll just die.
You're checking out the Opie and Anthony Show. Phone number 877-212-O-N-A.
These guys are laughing. The reporter's laughing, watching a runway model in Paris fall down.
Yeah.
It really is funny.
Yeah.
Her legs wobble.
Yeah, this runway model is just walking, and she, her legs wobble so badly for such a long time before she falls down. And this anchor and the other guy at the news desk, they are laughing hysterically. They cannot take it. They lost all sense of professionalism. It's great.
Because in her mind, she's got to be like, as she's wavering, you got to be saying like, I'm a model and I'm falling on the runway. There's nothing worse that can happen to a model on a runway than falling.
Than falling.
It's
and what
everything
else?
Wrong.
Well, we love to laugh so much that...
And they're news guys. These guys are anchormen.
Yeah.
I can't see them laughing at any other stories.
Well, Danny came up with a couple, and actually a listener out of nowhere. We didn't even ask for this. He sent one in as well. So you get the the reporters laughing over other things.
You geek.
What
That's
happened?
Great, though.
What happened? What happened?
She goes down like the walker in Return of the Jedi. Very... slow, wobbly legs. Come on. I gotta give Than. Come on. He's as big a geek as I am.
All right, here we go. This is from Danny. We start very easy here.
Mm-hmm.
A simple one.
The back motors of the ship are just holding it just enough to keep it. It bursts into flame.
That's embarrassing.
Well, you all are just for the children, by the way, aren't you?
It's not bad.
That's the famous Hindenburg broadcast.
we start easy, and the next one is way too fresh.
gets a little rough, does it?
Well, the Hindenburg. What year was that again?
That was 78.
78.
I don't know. 30. I'll say 38.
39.
37?
37, we'd be talking about, because it would be the 60th anniversary.
I'll say 37.
So it's got to be one of those weird years, like 30. Is it 37?
37.
Well, there you go.
I know my Nazi stuff.
May 6th.
I know my Nazi stuff, my friend.
May 6th, and we didn't celebrate that.
Why would we celebrate?
Could have been Hindenburg Tuesday.
Big swastika coming into Lakehurst.
Could have set one of our listeners on fire.
Well.
Here comes, he's in a WoW shirt. It's, oh no, oh, the catastrophe.
Well, that goes back 60 years. This next one goes back a mere 3 days.
Oh.
It's Tammy Faye.
Is the pain constant?
Yeah.
There she goes.
Yes, it is. My back hurts so bad. And in my stomach, I have a hard time swallowing food. That's the reason that I got lost in a toilet.
What do they give you for the pain?
They give me morphine.
Oh my God!
Hey man.
Okay.
Look, we acknowledge
that could be a bit too much, too soon.
It's wrong. We understand that. Look, that was Mike in Utah. Mike, cut it out.
Mike in Utah sent that in.
Yeah.
The whole state of Utah is on probation.
Spank your fanny for that one. Oh, 70 years. Sorry, Alex in New York City. You're correct.
I'm usually like only yesterday.
I'm usually good at math too.
But
what?
Isn't there another one?
Yeah, there is. There's one more.
Mm.
You like that one?
Yeah. As far as the news thing goes, sure.
Yeah, Drew Carey's the new host of The Price is Right. Terrific.
He's right for it. Rosie was too confrontational.
Mm-hmm. He never had a shot at that.
Of course not.
All right. And then our own Danny came up with this one. Oh, boy.
How you doing?
Cat has hurt. That's embarrassing.
Well, you all are just really tickled by that, aren't you?
I'm sorry.
guys. Come on. We want to apologize.
Hold on, hold on.
Oh my God!
Holy Jesus, Danny, that is horrid.
Wait a minute. Oh,
God. I had made the decision back in the office that I don't want to go to heaven.
Oh my God! We are officially garbage.
This is like the simplest bit you could do. It's just
combining two pieces of audio. When the model was falling and they're laughing, it's fine.
Right.
It's funny. I'm sure the model didn't have a good time doing it. But boy, you put that laugh to other things, it just becomes heinous.
When a brain-dead woman is slowly dying.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, it's not so funny.
And then the anchor goes, wait, hold on, wait. Oh. Wow.
Yeah.
Look, sorry. I want to apologize if any vegetables were offended
in the
by that remark.
Bit, yeah.
I'm sorry that I did that.
Bit.
Yeah. I'm embarrassed that I did that.
Wow. Right. That works.
I apologize to the Shivo family as well as broccoli and zucchini.
I'm going to meet with a couple of carrots and a tomato.
And, of course, an eggplant.
And apologize.
I'm going to go on the eggplant's radio show.
And
apologize. We're talking about vegetables. Calm down, everyone. No? What happened?
Nothing. www.overexplained.com.
Yeah.
It's also Perv News Thursday. You want to do some Perv News?
Yeah.
All right.
We named it for the day. We might as well do it.
Well, we noticed a while ago that every day there's some just bizarre, pervy story in the newspaper. So we kind of collect them.
Yeah.
And then we put them all together in one segment that we'd like to call Perv News.
Soon, a man appears wearing a red cap.
Uh-oh, I'm in trouble here.
One signal, he's there for sex. Deputies say he exposed himself three times during a canoeing trip.
Hey, look at my...
He walks naked with a ski mask covering his face. Now they say he's hiding on porches, looking through windows.
Opie and Anthony.
They're men, hunting for another man to have sex with.
And there you go. The intro to Perv News. That's pretty good. Dirk did that one.
That's a good one.
All right, so we got a bunch of good stories for Perv News Thursday. We could start with the ice cream guy.
Never good.
We could start with teen spanking girls. We could go with the man kept dead teen girl in closet.
Oh.
Or we could start with barbecue tools used in a rape, and a mom and son had to fight off the rapist.
Is there really a debate?
All right, I know which one.
I want dead teen in the closet.
Oh, see, I was going to go with barbecue mother-son rape. Whatever you want.
I'm going barbecue tools. You've been outvoted.
Well, can we do both?
Yeah, but the other thing is dead teen girl.
We'll do that after this one. We'll start with this one.
Yeah, we have to work up to hotness.
Yeah.
I hate getting voted down.
You're not, though. It was just...
Here we go.
Okay.
Here we go. Mother-son fight off child rapist with barbecue tools.
Oh, is it child rapist? See, that makes it creepy.
But my story is better.
John Jennings says that Friday afternoon, he was barbecuing out back, heard a child screaming for help, went to the alley, and that's where he found a teen assaulting a 7-year-old boy. He yelled to his mom to call police while he and the suspect just went at it. Fists were flying, and mainly his fists, to the attacker's face.
I just... punched him right in the face, and he put his hands up like this, and I grabbed him, and we went fighting, and I hollered for my mom to call the police. We fell down right here fighting, and if my mom come across, and she come across with her barbecue fork, and just juked him right in the rear.
That's a 7-year-old boy?
No,
that's obviously a horrific story, but it's kind of funny that the mom's
It worked out where,
kind of funny that the mom's poking the attacker with barbecue tools.
In his butt cheek.
In his butt cheek.
That's right. Mom wasn't far behind. She was armed with the only thing that she could find, which was a big barbecue fork. Meantime, 17-year-old Deshaun Ridge is in jail, charged with sexual assault of a child, bond set at $35,000. Police say there's no telling what could have happened had this mother and son not stepped in to help.
The thing is, like, why would a child rapist be given $35,000 bail? But if you rob a bank, it's probably $500,000. There's such a bit more... emphasis put on property.
It's only $3,500 cash, too, and you're out.
Yeah. Guys are trying to rape a 7-year-old.
10%. Holy jeez. This system stinks.
Yeah, it does.
Guy should have just killed him with a fork right there.
Yep.
God. And you know, I doubt you're ever going to find a child rapist that's brave enough or has the fighting ability to fight off somebody that comes over to kick their ass. You know, they always seem like this wormy type that you could just beat the crap out of.
And you don't recover from that. You don't become someone who's going to assault a 7-year-old in an alley and then all of a sudden go, oh, all right, I'm over it.
Yeah.
You don't change from that.
I just wanted to try it once, like skiing.
Squash them like bugs.
Absolutely. All right, well, Perv News didn't start off too well.
See, I wanted to do the tape. Thank you. I'm vindicated here. I know the cute story, fun story, is going to be the dead teen in the closet.
We like to work out our bits on the air. All right, we're going to acknowledge maybe Perv News should be more kind of, you know...
uplifting.
Silly stuff. Not stories like the one we just gave you.
I must admit that the fork in the butt cheek by Mom is kind of funny.
Well, that's why we went with that story, but...
But the prelude to that wackiness was a bit tragic.
Took away all the funny.
Yes, see, unfortunately.
I thought that they were assaulting, like the guy was trying to attack the mother and the kid ran out and hit him with barbecue stuff.
Yeah. See, you couldn't tell from the title. But dead teen in a closet.
Well, but first we got the ice cream owner.
Son of a bitch.
Stop this.
Why?
Why are you taking pictures?
Because someone was...
No, you can't take this. Stop and take it.
I can't take this picture.
49-year-old Gian Nagpal claims fired the girls.
These are stupid charges. There's a young person in a... Okay, they're taking drug actually, and I fired them.
But that's not what Suffolk County cops say. They believe he sexually abused the three high school students inside the ice cream parlor he manages.
Sexually abused by, all of a sudden he's groping them while they're trying to...
Yeah.
They're trying to just scoop out ice cream for a dumb summer job, and you got this creep.
Bend over. Get the rocky road.
Right.
Bend over.
He keeps all the ice cream really, like, far down.
Right. Where's short skirt?
Yeah, he keeps it either really far down or way up in the top shelf of the closet.
Reach for it. Reach.
Oh.
He's of a predator.
Ice cream
he
truck.
Seemed to have a method to his madness where he would... wait a couple of weeks after the girls were there, they would get comfortable. He would start explicit sexual conversations and then lead into the inappropriate touching.
Doesn't push up pop look like wiener? Push up pop look like wiener? Doesn't it? You eat it. No, the push up pop. What a creep.
Last week,
there's inappropriate conversations. I want to make vanilla on your back. I don't do that because then I pull out in chocolate all over.
This is a creepy bit. Let's be honest. All right,
ice cream men are just creeps.
Let's see what else is going on with this story.
Get into the inappropriate touching.
Last week, the Dix Hills man was arrested on third-degree sexual abuse after one of the teens complained to police.
I'm from Dix Hills. Get it? Dix Hills.
We're never going to get to the end of this clip.
Suck it. I mean this push-up pop. Come on.
Abuse after...
You like rocket pop?
Arrested on third-degree sexual abuse after one of the teens complained to police. This week, he was arrested again on two more counts after Suffolk County cops determined two other girls were also abused. He made bail and is back at work, but investigators are keeping a close eye and say these incidents were no accidents.
So the way the girls explained it, he always waited until he was out of the video camera's range in order to do what he did.
Oh,
wow.
Video camera. So is it a store or a truck? I can't even figure it out.
Store. Ice cream shop.
Oh.
Poof! Don't go in that bathroom. I just left a bunch of rocky road in there. You know? Someone light a match.
I think it's funny that he waits until they're off camera. Like, all of a sudden you see them having a conversation, then off camera you just see her head pop back in. Ow, 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 ow,
looking
ow.
At the camera mouthing, help, help.
Help me, please.
Is it cold in you or is it me?
See, is it cold in here? Okay, please hold.
Wait, I don't know. I'm not saying that's car crash.
Yeah.
Did you mean to say, is it cold in here?
No.
Oh, you meant to say that.
Yeah, because he's abusing them.
Oh, all right. All right, that was just...
I don't even know if it made it.
Who knows?
Look.
Why do my crashes have to be super analyzed?
What did he mean? Was it this or that? Or
because you don't get them
because you started that bit.
Damn it.
You don't get them that often.
Damn me.
So you do a lot of times, I think, you know what? I have faith in you. I'm like, I probably missed something.
Oh, thank you, Jimmy. I'm going to be your book signing.
Normally
Carl Place tonight.
Normally I didn't, and the bomb was horrible and deserved. But it came. See, after the book signing plug that I faked.
All right. Moving on.
What about...
What?
Shut up!
You wanted the closet girl.
Oh, I thought you were going to goof on me more.
Oh, you wanted the girl?
Yes, come on, let's get right to the best story.
Right after
it's
this
be.
One. Herb News continues.
Well, two teenage boys are now facing sex abuse charges after slapping girls' behinds in school. The alleged abuse happened at a middle school in Oregon. The two boys were sent to the principal's office after hitting the girls and later ended up in juvenile prison for 5 days. Now they could face 10 years behind bars. If they're convicted. Many, including the boys' parents, say it was really a school prank and the charges are unfair.
At first, we thought it was an example to the other students in the school. But then on Monday, before he was released on Tuesday, the DA did not want to release him still.
He is the little, he looks like Harry Potter from the first movie.
Oh, really?
Yeah. He's like this little innocent looking kid. And apparently they don't go to the story doesn't tell what they were doing.
He was slapping girls' asses.
Were they just walking up and slapping their asses, or was it more violent, like pinning down and
no, it was
slapping? Because a regular walk in the hallway, slap on the ass, it's inappropriate. But prison, get out of here!
It's just innocent kid crap. That's all that was going on.
That was going on in school.
Yeah.
When I went to school,
back in the
rape
day.
Was allowed.
Yeah, right.
It was wonderful.
I just said, you're right, like there was a possibility that was true. What an idiot.
In the schoolhouse.
I suck.
I once got Laura Ingalls behind the barn.
All right.
That is funny you said, yeah, right.
I know.
Funny, though.
I know.
Just a reflex.
I just had to stop the whole show to acknowledge how dumb that was.
Colin.
What an idiot.
Colin is the funniest line ever about your friends who don't understand sarcasm.
Yeah.
Your adult friends. He goes, like, I worked out a little bit, and I came out of the gym, and I'm like, yeah, I'm ready to fight Tyson. And my friend's like, yeah, right, he'll kick your ass.
That's stupid.
Like Colin's joke about men that don't get... I think that was directed at stupid Bob Kelly, too. I think this
was it.
Yeah.
All right. Moving on with Perv News.
Oh, thanks.
Nope, not yet.
Damn it.
Family says I-4 rage led to mooning.
Why do I have to suffer during these date-themed days? Well, it's always me that suffers.
Well, we're just trying to get the fun back into this dumb segment.
I think dead teen in a closet is a laugh riot.
All right, if convicted of flashing a teenager, the man could receive 15 years in prison and be a sex offender.
What was he
for
doing?
For mooning. A family driving west on Interstate 4 on Sunday evening made the men in the black Tahoe very mad.
Do you see how finished we are as a country? This guy's facing 15 years. Those dummies for smacking asses did 5 days and are facing 10 years. And that guy's trying to assault a 7-year-old for real in an alley. And they get $35,000 bail, 10% he can get out.
And they're out, yeah.
We stink.
So a car pisses off the Tahoe, okay?
Mm-hmm.
The Mercedes had cut them off. The Tahoe's driver later told a deputy. So front seat passenger John Thomas Taylor dropped his pants and mooned the family.
Okay.
So he was pissed that this car cut him over, so he decides to moon the family, including their 14-year-old son. Taylor, 21, was arrested and hauled to jail, accused of committing a lewd and...
lascivious?
Yes, thank you. Lascivious act in the presence of a child younger than 16. If convicted of the charge, just for mooning, Taylor could face up to 15 years in prison and forever be identified as a sex offender.
That's good. That's balanced.
All right, look. Did he do of just a moon... Or did he include the fruit bowl? Because when you do include the fruit bowl...
What, that makes it different?
That could be
lewd and lascivious.
Yeah.
A moon is innocent.
A moon really.
A mooning is very innocent.
But from the back, if the pants are down far enough, it looks like Ziggy peeking over the fence.
Yeah, I think a regular mooning through a car window is one of the most innocent things. Come on.
Oh, yeah.
Pushing it because a kid's in the car. 14 years old boy. Like, he hasn't mooned.
Absolutely.
You ever been behind a school bus and, you know, the youngsters coming home from a little volleyball match?
No, but it's my dream.
Yes.
Decide to start mooning and doing some crazy stuff?
I follow school buses. I dare you to moon me my license plate.
you ever get behind a school bus with, like, high school girls in it?
That's what I'm getting.
In the back, and you get...
I've seen them
don't
moon.
Don't you get all... I get very inhibited. Like, I sit up and like, I don't want to look like an idiot.
You don't want
to... It just goes back to, like, your high school days.
You don't want to see them, you don't want them to see you drooling.
Yeah, you don't want them to point and laugh, is what you don't want them to do. It brings you right back to your own high school days when you're looking at high school girls in the back of a school bus looking at you.
Yeah.
And you're trying to just not acknowledge them, yet you want to look at them, but you don't want... to see them looking at you and laughing, or they turn to a friend and the friends both look and start laughing, and then you just got to start ramming the back of the bus and then just hope they fall out that emergency exit and run them over.
Oh, they tease you.
Oh, are they teases?
They know what they're doing.
Little fucker.
Horse.
All right, here we go. Here's the big get for perv
news.
The old
hockey stick.
Here's the big get for the perv news.
Yeah.
This is creepy. Downright creepy.
A Florida man is facing murder charges after a dead teenage girl is found in his closet. His father is the one who made that gruesome discovery. 26-year-old Jason Shenfield claims 18-year-old Amanda Buckley overdosed on drugs and he panicked. But an autopsy revealed Buckley was strangled, beaten, and sexually assaulted.
Jesus, nice way to cover it up. She OD'd.
Yeah.
This is like beating marks, strangled, and sexually assaulted.
Yeah. That guy's never watched Forensic Investigators.
No. He has not watched CSI.
His parents turned him into police, but the suspect's father went out and got a lawyer and brought him back to the house before making this chilling 911 call.
Can you please repeat your message?
Yes. No, I want to report a drug overdose.
Who had a drug overdose?
Pardon?
Who had a drug overdose?
Oh, this girl on the...
Okay, is she there with you?
Yeah, she's in my son's room.
How old is she?
I think she's 18, 19, something like that.
Is she awake?
Oh, no, I think she's dead.
Is she cold to the touch?
I'm pretty distraught over this whole thing.
I would go.
This isn't perv news, by the way. What is this about? You think that?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, yeah.
You think they were just doing some drugs and the girl OD'd? What?
Oh, no. I don't know.
He raped her and he probably strangled her. They're probably getting high together and he raped and strangled her.
A ghoul.
Now she looks like the chick from the original Ring.
Oh.
The closet door. The jaw drop.
I saw her face.
Dumb jaw drop.
That
was kind of funny.
Oh, it was creepy.
What a frightened gal.
She was very scared.
Let's go to Boston. Alex, what's up?
Little Alex.
Hey, Alex.
A couple years ago.
What happened?
We were driving through Worcester, and guy cut us off. Me and another guy in the back seat of our car, we mooned him. He took down the license plate number. The driver got arrested. Me and my buddy in the back seat got arrested. We all got charged with indecent exposure.
Are you for a mooning? That's ridiculous.
Decent exposure.
It took 2 years and a really good lawyer to get out of it. We ended up getting charges dropped, but it was a huge pain in the ass.
Well, how'd you get out of it? Would you just tell them that it was E-Rock in the back seat looking out the window? Sorry, E-Rock. No offense.
Well, that's
none taken, I'm sure.
All right, Alex.
I didn't know that was a crime.
See, it happens. All right, here's the last clip. Man kept dead teen in closet.
The father became suspicious. His son lives at home. He's 26 years old. Would apparently lock the bedroom door every time he left the house, right? Oof. And that raised his suspicion, so that's when he checked the room?
Correct. Apparently that day, the mother wanted to do some laundry and wanted Jason's bedroom sheets. And at first he said the sheets didn't need to be cleaned, and then of course he brought out the bottom sheet, locked the door each time, and was acting unusual. He then left. The father then went in to retrieve the top sheet, which Jason said didn't need cleaning, and then found Amanda dead in the closet.
But the father then went and got a lawyer, brought the lawyer back to the house, and then made that 911 call an hour later. Do you see any charges being filed against the father here, Captain?
Right now, we do not see any charges being filed against the charges unless, as we proceed through the investigation, we determine that he was an actual principal in the murder. But right now, we don't see any charges being filed.
Stupid question.
Yeah, why would you charge the father? It's his son, and he's panicking. Like, oh, my God, this is my son. What the heck is
I'm a little distraught about this.
You see any charges? Snarky reporters.
Yeah. I think maybe something put behind that 911 call might be a little... might perk it up a little bit.
Oh, really? Well, here you go, Danny. You never know. We'll give it a try. Let's say hi to Michelle. Michelle, what's going on?
That's so cool.
I just want to say I get Anthony today, and if I wasn't fat and old, he'd be mine.
No.
Michelle.
Sweetie.
See, I have this image on the air that is very negative. People think I don't like fat or older women, and they're right, but I would be willing to talk to you over the phone like this.
Okay, but you know what? I have a set of knockers you'd die for.
So. Oh, how big a gal are you?
I can't. I'm two of me.
No, how big a gal? Don't worry, we tease on this show.
We don't know you. How much do you weigh?
A lot.
Well, how much? No one could see you, Michelle.
We'd love to just know, because we kind of survey the audience.
Anthony, let me just tell you, you can't even bench press me.
Well, all right, but how much?
Could any human?
Out.
Are you over 250 pounds?
No.
Okay, all see? Right. We're thinking higher. So what is it? About two bills?
Yeah, but you know, the height doesn't constitute the weight.
What was that?
Michelle, what was that?
I get it.
No.
Anyway, I love you guys. Everything you suck, I love you.
Thank you, Michelle.
She wanted to say that you're real funny today, Anthony.
But oh,
she
went thank off on you, Michelle. Tangent.
She's a huge fan of yours. She said, Anthony's really, really funny today.
The pigs love me. Just, I don't know what it is. I remember wherever we'd go. Like, these fat chicks seem to dig me.
Nothing
which
wrong.
Which is fine.
Nothing wrong with fat.
I don't mind that. But she's got, I got a pair of knockers you'd love. If you know Anthony. The true Anthony.
Mm-hmm.
You'd know, I'm not into, like, giant boobs. I don't like them.
Especially not a big girl. You lift them up, they smell like a lamb kebab.
From behind. Well, an Arizona store owner...
Who's getting it from behind?
Someone
what?
Was from behind.
From behind.
Exactly how they fit from behind.
Oh, okay.
Well, an Arizona store owner has the answer, which he calls... Are you ready for this?
Yes.
The butt cam.
The butt cam.
That's funny stuff. The butt cam.
Are you ready for this?
Yes.
The butt cam. He hooked up a camera and a flat screen, and the days of people twisting and turning are, well, shall we say, behind them. So far, this is the only store of its kind, but the owner thinks the idea will catch on.
No, it won't. How about this? You put a camera on someone's cock, and you fucking see your ass rapidly approaching, you know, to get out of the way. Stupid butt cam.
I see that being put on a hard disk somewhere, the camera, and it being sold on websites with a Foundry logo on it. Because it's just a camera hooked up to a TV monitor.
Right.
But and that way... drive traffic to somebody's buttock.
Yes.
And that way, instead of having to put your ass into the mirror and then you turn your head over your shoulder, you could look at the TV monitor and the camera's facing your ass, and now you can look straight up and see how you look from behind.
Or forget the technology and just buy another mirror and put them both and look at them.
Right.
No, you don't understand. There's a lot of people that won't put something up with the Opie and Anthony name on it. Well, who are they? I checked my email. Scroll.
Why?
I hope the traffic gets driven into a Prius on its way to Jersey.
Where's that bastard?
Why did this make the news?
Yeah, it's a camera. This isn't like the future is here. A camera?
Have you ever had a problem looking at your ass?
No.
They usually have the mirrors set up perfectly. Like, all right, that's how my ass looks. Great. I guess I'll buy them.
And you just give a 2-second look.
Right.
If you look too much and you're a guy, feig. Feig.
Ooh, I look good.
Yeah, that's a nice ass.
Look at that ass. Look at that ass!
That's some ass.
All right.
I
don't mean to keep prompting you, but I just love it. All right, here's a little more news for everybody. Who cares about the butt cam?
Well, it helped Marty McFly and Doc Brown get back to the future. Now the DeLorean sports car is making a comeback. Take a look. The car is currently being resurrected in a Texas warehouse. It's known for its most recognizable features, like the distinctive gull-wing doors and stainless steel exterior. One entrepreneur plans to begin hand-making 2 DeLoreans a month.
With heavy-duty shocks for Michael J. Fox. Well, you know.
Yeah. He won't get a stick, you know, reverse second first, stall go, back up.
Going through transmissions like crazy.
I know his tranny will drop in the showroom floor. Have to have a trunk full of transmissions. Go reverse, stop, back up. All right, we get it.
One entrepreneur plans to begin hand-making 2 DeLoreans a month. Starting next year. Now that's an ambitious project.
Are people interested in buying DeLoreans?
No.
Probably the classic ones, but they've been coming up in the news lately. People get so nostalgic every 20 years or so. They get all freaked out and have to go back and start buying up crap from the 80s right now. And then whatever that 20-year mark is, people start going, I could use a DeLorean.
They get nostalgic?
Yeah, they get all nostalgic. DeLorean driving down the road always looked... cares?
Man wakes up during his own autopsy. This is an amazing story. We had it the other day, and we never got to it.
Didn't happen at the Mayo Clinic.
Huh?
They're making it sound like... I hate when I go to, like, Drudge Report or something, and I click on a story going, oh, my God, that sounds horrible. Man wakes up during his own autopsy.
Yeah.
And I find out it was in Peru or somewhere. Then you realize, oh, okay, that makes total sense because they don't really know. They put a mirror to his mouth and see if it steams up.
Do something silly. They throw sugar on him, and if demons don't rise up, he's dead.
Even better. Dummies.
In Venezuela, a man dead in a car crash.
Same thing.
Wakes up.
Yeah. Shut up.
So
my geography is way off today.
In Venezuela, a man declared dead in a car crash wakes up, but get this, during his own autopsy. According to the newspaper El Universal, medical examiners began the procedure on Carlos Camejo.
By the way, to say get this. We would have picked up the odd part as you said.
Yeah, hey, get this. Hold on to your hats, kids.
You know, and he woke up during an autopsy. Wait, what's the weird part?
What?
Get this. Oh. Well, we know something crazy is about to happen.
Get ready, because here it comes.
Right.
Examiners began the procedure on Carlos Camejo, but they stopped when he began bleeding. The man says that he woke up in excruciating pain. His wife arrived at the hospital and was shocked to find him walking around. Wow.
Can't make this up, folks. No one thought you did, stupid. No one thought you made it up.
Can't make this up, folks.
But we just did. Joke's on you.
I like turtles.
I know, yeah.
Great.
Stop with the turtles.
Little box turtle.
The guy's laying there for his autopsy, right?
Yeah.
And they don't want to get too graphic, I guess, on the news, but basically they start slicing into his face.
Why the face? I thought they did the classic Y cut first.
Yeah.
They do like the overall body. They look at everything. And then they do that Y cut. Shoulder to... breastbone.
And then hang you.
And then breastbone to stomach.
They hang you and let the blood
belly,
drain out.
And then they open you up and look around.
Mm.
And then Spicoli goes, whoa! You're about to see the body in its pristine state.
Yeah. I love that movie.
Imagine you wake up and you're being cut and you say, what are you doing? And they say, oh, we were doing an autopsy on you.
Yeah.
Oh.
See, we thought you were dead.
Don't they have a test in that stupid country they do?
Venezuela.
Well, pinching your nose for at least 2 minutes.
See if the guy goes...
The guy
alive.
The guy woke up because the pain was unbearable as they're slicing into his face.
Well, whatever caused him to be dead,
yeah.
Wasn't it some kind of accident?
Car crash.
Yeah. wasn't that excruciating pain? Like, he would have woken up in pain anyway. They cut his face with a scalpel, and that's what caused the pain?
And how fast they do an autopsy?
Yeah, really.
They just wheel the guy in.
Wow.
We have to take him to the... no, just put him on the table. We'll do the autopsy. I'm going somewhere for the weekend.
All right, it is Fun Fact Thursday. Let's say hi to Louie in New York. Louie!
Nice work, Lou.
Louie! What's going on with the phones today?
Oh, my God.
Louie? All right.
No.
Let's say hi to Nancy in Pittsburgh. Nancy.
Hi, good morning.
Two calls from Pittsburgh today. What's up, Pittsburgh?
Nice.
I love you guys.
Thank you.
Well, you might want to tell a friend or two.
Yeah.
Thanks, Nancy.
Spread the word.
Yeah, please. That's why we call it the virus, the ONA virus. We need your help to spread the word of the show.
They're wearing SARS masks. They're not spreading the virus.
No, not at all.
Help out.
Well, we have the MRSA virus going around right now.
The what?
MRSA.
The Marsha?
What?
I think it's MRSA. They say that it's an antibiotic-resistant infection that athletes are getting.
Is that a fun fact?
That's a creepy fact. And what does this virus do to you?
I don't know. I guess it could kill you eventually. I don't know.
Probably headache and diarrhea.
There's some...
It starts with a boil. And they're saying that you got to make sure you wash your gym clothes and your athletic things every day.
Who does that?
It's on the news.
No one.
Yeah, there's some microscopic organism that's going to just take us all out eventually.
Yeah.
It's just hanging out somewhere waiting for someone to touch it.
Waiting to strike.
It's there on a leaf somewhere and some dopey hiker's going to touch it and that's going to be the end of civilization.
Not like all we need is something as deadly as like AIDS that is transmitted just through the air.
Yeah.
That would just be devastating. To this planet.
Well, the monkeys got it. Simian AIDS was actually transmittable, and we're finished.
Was it?
Yeah.
I got 80 jokes I can't tell.
Yeah. And I'm sure at least three of them will overlap with the 80 that I'm thinking. But I mean, they could not. They were freaked out because they said if it went to humans, I mean, we were in trouble. But they thought they were passing it back and forth in the lab.
Mm-hmm.
Monkeys that never connected, like
50, yeah, we're getting it.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah.
An airborne like. Virus like that.
Yeah, simian AIDS.
Where it's fatal, there's no cure for it, and it would be airborne. That's pretty sick.
Yeah, it would suck.
Oof.
Let's
rule.
Nancy,
get
what?
Get rid of some of these people.
What did you have, Nancy?
Well, you kept playing that Mr. Bucket song this morning.
Yeah.
And I need to ask you to stop, or I'm going to have to quit listening to your show because the H2O song goes through my head constantly because of you guys.
Constantly.
What is that song again? Hell no, the H2O.
I like Mr. Bucket myself.
Yeah, we like the Mr. Thank you, Nancy. Jay in Michigan, what's up?
Hey, Jimmy, I just wondering how Quincy would have handled that autopsy.
Oh, he probably would have been very surprised. Sam, you got to check the bodies. They're constantly getting up and walking out.
It's a brilliant Quincy, man.
It's hard to do an autopsy, Sam, when the guy is talking to you.
A woman comes in with a flat ass and goes out with her.
I blame Quincy because he's too busy on that yacht with that bimbo.
That bimbo with the long, flat ass.
Right.
What's the matter, Quince? I was cutting into his face and he talked to me, Sam. He spoke to me.
He picked that chick up from the slab. That's why her ass is so flat. It was just sitting on a cold slab.
The blood coagulated in the lower spine, Sam. There was no cushion for the pushing, Sam. That's why I need you.
The best Quincy ever.
Oh, it's amazing. Jimmy. And for the new listeners that want to really get involved with the whole Quincy thing on the show, you know, just go to YouTube or break.com and watch the Quincy show intro or whatever.
Yes.
You get to see the babe with the flat ass on the yacht.
Flat ass.
Like Quincy's just
big, long. It's 3 feet long.
It's not even a yacht. It's a houseboat that probably smells like an outhouse, like a backed up toilet.
Big Quincy dumps.
Sam, I need you to snake your hand down into the toilet. You got tiny hands, Sam.
Do an autopsy on his bowl.
I don't even eat corn, Sam. What happened?
Where did it come from? He's all upset. Doesn't know where the corn came from. It's the whole episode.
Hey, Quince.
I'm watching it right now. There's Quince looking under the microscope.
Yes.
There's Quince removing the sheet over the... Taking the sheet off the dead guy
in front
now.
Of the cops, and the cops all faint.
Yeah, because they're not used to it.
He goes, you are
it.
Now ready to enter the world of forensic medicine. And he peels the sheet off, and everyone goes
passes
down and
out.
Faints.
There
and
you
he's
go.
Just standing there like, what?
And now here's
he's
the fun Quincy.
Yeah.
Here's fun Quincy.
Now he's having some fun, because it's not just about work, it's about Quincy playing.
Yeah, look at that.
The goofy music.
Looks like he's examining a dead body, but oh no, it's not a
no.
dead body.
When
it's
they pan back,
bimbo.
You realize it's that flat-assed whore.
Look, there's the flat-ass.
There she is. Ugh.
On his
oh, what an awful ass.
She's 19, he's 71. Throat cancer and a martini.
I guess being a coroner pays well, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah, there he is, shaving and going out.
I saw your ass. I thought you were two-dimensional. She has an ass like a hologram. She just stinks.
It was such a dumb show. He's a coroner, yet he was involved with the investigations. Like, he'd be out and explosions are going off, and he'd be near him.
But in one,
and the criminals are there, and he's catching them.
There's like three little windows, and in one, like, he's laughing with a drink and an awful suit jacket, and the other one, there's an avalanche happening.
Yeah, an avalanche, and the other one, he's cutting someone open.
No, that's a car going
what's
off
he
a
doing?
Cliff.
Yeah, car's going off a cliff.
It's always adventure with Quincy.
Because one car's going off a cliff.
Yeah, let's see.
Upper right.
Yeah.
He's laughing with a drink.
In one, he's a car going upper left, car going down in the right. Now he's looking at an X-ray, and in the now
flat ass.
He's pinching her fat arm. How come you have all this fat on your arm and not on your ass? That's what he's looking at. If he can operate and move her arm flab to her ass.
To her ass.
Her ass is terrible, like Sam's face.
Just pop Quincy nose. Quincy ME into your search engine for for your video.
Love the Quince.
All right, a couple other things going on here today. Well, we got the hooker mom snorting the coke off the baby's stomach. That's just terrific.
That's a good one.
That's an amazing story.
You don't hear that. You usually hear about guys and the thing to say is, drinking at the strip club and snorting lines off of strippers' backs or something like that. This kind of takes a little far. What is this woman, a prostitute?
She's a prostitute.
Yeah. You're a prostitute?
And she was apparently had kids in the car while she was servicing clients.
Kids in the car? Yeah.
That's a man act.
I got my young son in the car and you're snorting coke off his belly.
One of the funniest lines ever. I happen to have my young son in the car. Kids 50 with a pistol.
Young son. Hold my hat.
Ready?
Yes.
Ready.
Police say Cook's 5-year-old daughter and 8-week-old son were with her as she stayed out all night long having sex and doing drugs. Kumi Tucker has our top story live from Schenectady. Good evening, Kumi.
Good evening, Jim. Police say at one point, Cook even snorted cocaine off the baby's stomach as she was breastfeeding. Police say 37-year-old Wendy Cook of Caroline Street in Saratoga took her 2 young children with her as she worked as a prostitute.
And the funny thing is she's doing coke while breastfeeding, so the kid's probably getting some kind of coke Jones.
Yeah, because that happens.
Well, what is she supposed to do? Get a babysitter?
Oh, dude,
she's a hooker.
That's going to cut into the profits.
Absolutely. There's worse things she could have done while the kid was breastfeeding.
Kids are done anyway. Yeah, true.
Yeah, those kids are just done. Been out all night selling sex and smoking crack and snorting cocaine while her children were with her, an infant son only 8 weeks old and a 5-year-old daughter who was awake during some of the sexual encounters.
While the two kids were in the car, through our investigation, we learned that she performed oral sex on at least 2 Johns, again, while her 5-year-old was awake in the back seat and while her 8-week-old was in the back seat. Also, over the course of the evening, she smoked crack cocaine and 10 to 12 occasions over the course of the night, again, with her children in the back seat.
See, there are worse mothers than Britney Spears out there.
But, gee, she didn't leave the kids alone.
She's not an absentee
kinda
mom.
Nice.
Dr. Laura would like that. She's her kid's mom. Dr.
Right.
Laura says that.
It was take your kids to work day.
Police say Cook even did drugs while breastfeeding, snorting cocaine off the infant's stomach. Four other women, all from Schenectady, were also arrested in the police operation targeting prostitution. But Cook faces the most serious charges. She is now in jail without bail.
The kid was too busy to know that that the mom was doing the coke on his stomach.
That doesn't seem like a good place to put coke to do it. Kids make it smooth. Their kids are sweaty.
Kids making eye contact with a John who's working on the other one. I'm thirsty too, kid. They're high-fiving, both doing lines off each other's stomachs. Kid's kicking its baby feet. The guy's getting high. It's fun for everyone.
Everyone's having a good time.
People are acting like a bunch of sticks in the mud with this one. I think it's kind of a cute story.
Yeah.
She's charged with, like, drugs and prostitution and being a goose.
It's a single mom taking care of her kids.
She. And should marry this reporter, so her name would be Kumi Kumia.
Yes, I was thinking that. Kumi Kumia.
Kumi Kumia. Hey, we got another quick one before we take a break here.
Jacker's in your wedding room.
We got another school teacher story. This is really good, too.
Is it sexy?
Well,
a history lesson at a local middle school prompts a teacher to apologize.
That apologize comes after she uses a crossword puzzle to teach her students the N-word. News Channel 9's Steph Seymour is back from
Wait, wait.
All right, what are they thinking?
Oh, boy. Don't do this, Cos.
Hold on. Now, I maybe we can address this. I wonder what questions they asked.
Six-letter word. All right.
Seth Seymour is back from Sequatchie County, Tennessee, with the story. Seth.
Kim, school officials say this was a bad move, assigning a crossword puzzle to teach a word that triggers so much hate.
Clifford Brannon was left speechless by the history lesson his fifth-grade son brought home.
That's good.
He
can't talk.
On this crossword puzzle about the Civil War, there were simple vocabulary words like cabin, smokehouse, lantern. But then there was this word.
The word N-I-G-G-E-R.
Along with
excuse
its
me.
Blue.
Did he just spell it out?
He spelt it.
He spelled
it. Further than I've seen him go recently, though. Usually they just say the N-word, but that would be one-letter word.
Maybe that's the new way of doing radio. We just spell things out.
Can we do that?
No.
Can we do that?
I'm sure not in any derogatory context.
But of course not. But like a child.
Like in this story, you can. But not not just spell it out.
Along with its clue, 17 across, an insulting way to label a black person.
All right.
Okay.
It is.
Yeah.
And it's a Civil War crossword puzzle? It might have been a little insensitive of the teacher.
That's an awful.
There's really no way, no reason to put that in.
No, not at all.
It's not something you want to teach, you know. I wouldn't put it out there to be taught that way.
His son's teacher assigned the homework Friday as a supplement to the book his class at Sequatchie County Middle School is reading. The book, Sounder, is widely used in classrooms nationwide to illustrate the Civil War through the eyes of a young black boy. Teaching history is fine, according to this father, but he says putting out a word like this in a crossword puzzle crosses the line between history and hate.
Well, it doesn't... All right.
No, nah, don't go to that extent either, where it's hate. It's just the guy being kind of stupid.
Just kind of made a mistake there.
Just change one letter and put Roy Rogers horse. That's all you got to do.
Is that his horse's name?
Trigger.
Trigger.
Oh.
Wouldn't work. It's two letters and...
Yeah, well. Oh.
Here at Sequatchie County Middle School, the Civil War is part of the fifth grade curriculum, and that means dealing with some pretty heavy and controversial words, but school officials now admit this worksheet is not the way to do it.
Worksheet. Who's tiger friend?
Donald Johnson, a mistake was made. This word should have never come up on a worksheet like this. I can't defend it. Johnson says the fifth grade teacher pulled the worksheet from the website edhelper.com. He says she was aware the word was listed, but justified it as a way to teach students about its bad connotations. But Clifford Brannon says it was not a lesson his son should have learned.
Especially when you're trying to teach your children something that, you know, that you don't want them to say, then they, you know, teach that in school.
Now, we tried to contact the website that created the lesson, but never got a reply. As for the teacher, she contacted the parents today and apologized. She will not be punished.
Can I say that this reporter... Wait, is there a way to play the opening? The one thing he said, the first thing he says again, he is the worst. He should never talk again. He's a terrible...
A lesson at a local middle school prompts a teacher to...
Oh, yeah, well, I'd have to find it again.
What is he doing?
Huh?
What is he doing on the news?
He's cleaning his nose out.
He's pouring water up one nostril, and it's pouring out the other.
Yeah, that's how you clean out your nose.
You just say, no, it isn't.
This out works tremendously well, and a lot of people suffer. Well, can I tell you, it's a real, actual thing that people do. No.
They're goofing on it.
Stop smoking, eat a healthy diet, make sure you drink a lot of fluids, and buy yourself a humidifier to keep the air moist. Dry air can aggravate the sinuses. No joke. That was not for entertainment value. That is very seriously
but it was.
A good treatment.
What did it
hey,
feel
if you
like?
Have a question for me, log on to our website, cw11.com.
Nice.
I'll answer it right here for you. The answer is it feels like you're really flushing out and getting all the congestion out of your nose. And it really, really is recommended by sinus specialists for people who suffer.
It doesn't give you that feeling of like when water goes up your nose? Like
no, not really, because it kind of gradually and it passes through the sinus.
Doing it again. Good, they're goofing on them.
I should tell you, they also have irrigators. Isn't that hilarious?
It looks like a little bong.
And now you got to do the other side. You go and you do both sides. Now, they have irrigators like water pick-like devices. Don't stick a water pick in your nose, by the way. Not a good idea. No, because it'll cause bleeding, but they have special devices that do it as well. But it really is a medical treatment. I don't make this stuff up.
Dr. Steve, taking one for the team.
There you go.
Thanks, pal.
Dr. Steve is going to be very angry with them. He was trying to do a serious piece, and they were laughing at him.
What, cleaning out your nose?
Yeah.
With a little teapot device?
I use a saline spray. I blast it. Like it's just like water. It's a terrible feeling, but it does help.
It clears it all out?
A little bit. That helps. You know, I have
yeah, you know, it's hard for me to believe that pouring water up your nostril doesn't make it feel like water's going up your nose. Yeah. Because that's what you're doing. You're putting water up your nose. Ugh.
I had a leaky humidifier and it rotted a few of the floor tiles.
Ew.
I know. I got a wooden floor tile.
Oh, in your new nice place.
Yeah, it's just a...
Oh, son of a... Bitch.
Son of a gun. Let's keep it friendly.
Okay,
yeah,
sorry.
Let's say hi to Karen in New Jersey before we take a break here. Karen, what's up?
Hey, I just wanted to say the teacher could have changed the crossword puzzle to what E-Rock gets every day.
What's that?
Fatter?
Oh, you stepped on our line.
Jimmy, that rarely happens.
Oh, wow.
Do it again,
Jimmy.
Miss. I'm sorry.
Bigger.
Yes, that would have been the word.
Hey, we mentioned this. Baltimore distributes no candy home signs to sex offenders for Halloween.
Yeah.
We're kind of joking about this, but this was a story that hit yesterday. To discourage contact with children, some registered sex offenders in the state of Maryland will be asked to post signs at their homes that say, no candy at this residence on Halloween.
Unconstitutional.
That's what, Uncle Paul?
Unconstitutional.
Oh, you want to fight this?
Man shouldn't have to hang a sign when he's just trying to hand out candy to little youngsters.
Oh my God, I hate that voice.
Trick or treat. Let me smell your feet.
Give you something good to eat.
Yeah, it makes a little rhyme.
Oh, yeah. For the second straight year.
Your little princess eyes? Come on in. I'll give you something. Yeah, the magic wand.
Probation agents plan a team with local police to dissuade sex offenders who are not allowed to have contact with children from participating in the holiday.
Why?
Huh?
Why?
In addition to the signs, all such offenders have been advised in a letter to stay home.
Stay at home.
So you have to put a big sign on your front door and then you got to stay inside. And they got to be inside from 6 p.m. on Halloween until the next morning. They got to leave their lights off and refuse to answer their doors.
It's like insanity day for them.
Oh, you
imagine a day where one day a year you're at home and the hottest chicks just come to your door scantily clad.
Yeah, let's just come up with a new holiday so everyone can understand what's going on here.
And it's just hot chicks.
And it's hot chick day.
Hot chick day. And you're like, whoa, damn, there's a hot chick.
Hot chick.
Whoa.
They wear a little outfit and you give them a little something something.
That's what this is for pedophiles.
Yeah.
It's hot chick day.
They have to put a sign on the door. They got to turn all the lights off, and then they just got to sit on a couch and sweat all night.
Just sit there. Oh, God.
Oh my God.
All that goodness out there, and I can't even partake. Poor little kids. Some creep behind his closed door sitting in the dark with his night vision goggles looking out the window.
I want to go to Kinko's and get no candy signs made, like hundreds of them.
Put them on people's doors.
Just do the whole neighborhood.
Oh, that's funny.
You got to peek through the little letter. Did anyone say that? The little letter slot?
Yeah.
No, there's a reason no one said that.
There will be some houses where it's a sex offender's house and there's not a no candy sign posted. But in all those instances, someone will be going to the house to make sure the right thing is happening at that house.
Mm-hmm.
So the authorities,
the right thing.
The authorities will be dressing up as hot little kids, I guess, and knocking on some of these doors to make sure they don't answer.
I'm Chris Hansen. I'm looking for candy. Trick or treat, why don't you sit down over there?
How awful is that? You hear, got any candy, mister? And you open the door with your robe askew. It's a cop. Because a pedo is so eager to get that door open.
Oh, yeah.
You just open it quickly with your robe askew, and the wind knocks your robe open even farther, and it's a policeman.
Where's your sign, sir? Oh, I don't have one.
Yeah, like the little things that tie your robe are hanging all willy-nilly, like you're like a real... Like you're like a real rich guy, you know, yeah. On his yacht.
Hey, but you're just completely nude, and you got one hand on your hip or something.
Yeah.
Hey, hi. Uh-oh.
Yes. Yes. Are you a superhero? No, you're not. You're a policeman.
An awful big child dressed as a cop. bunch of creeps. Oh, I gotta just sit here. I can't even get up off the couch. Don't get up.
Oh, for the love of God, go away. Oh. Just go away.
If it's a... But what if he's dressed in a Spider-Man uniform, showing off his tights? Oh, boy, what'll I do?
Anyone home?
Oh, I should say something.
Good evening. No, my health doesn't allow it. Hello, anyone inside?
Try the wine.
I was trying to get him drunk.
An eerie sight for my monster from his land.
Yes. These are the people, too, that get a little too into it. Look, I've made a haunted house. Come on in.
Yeah.
All right, walk through my haunted house. But mister, this goes upstairs. Yes, it does. To the scariest place of all. The Dungeon of Horror. It's also known as my bedroom.
This isn't scary. There's no ghosts or goblins in this apartment. There's just one little skeleton nailed up to the wall.
The real horror is upstairs. It's a fear that lasts a lifetime.
That you'll pass on to future generations.
Right.
Well, how about the greatest guy ever? The guy who tried to hang his wife in a haunted house?
Yeah.
Yeah.
This guy rules.
Yeah, well, what's going on with that
Halloween story? Starting a little early.
This guy from Spokane, Washington wanted to avoid a divorce, so he took his wife to the garage to show her a haunted house he created, and then he tried to hang her. I love this guy, because his wife was, she's got, like, rope burns on her neck, and apparently, She didn't realize, I guess, the marriage was going bad, so he goes, I have a haunted house in the garage, and he made her climb the ladder and test the noose, and then he turned up the radio and kicked the ladder out.
Wow.
Test that noose, honey, while I turn the radio on, and stupid, put the noose around her neck, and he boots the ladder out.
How the hell did she get down?
Right. Well, she was hanging there, and then she, they said she often needs a wheelchair to get around, but she was able to periodically support herself on her tiptoes. And she said at the last minute she was able to escape, but she had to promise him that she wouldn't divorce him, and she'd never tell anyone what he had done.
That promise went awry.
I promise not to leave you or tell the police that you're trying to hang me right now. What a dope he is to believe that.
Yeah, at that point, you gotta, like, kill her.
That's under duress.
All right. All right, I'll take you out of the noose, but, honey, yeah, test this guillotine I've made. It's wonderful. Just put your head in there.
She really tested it.
Well, she stood on her tiptoes and put her head in the old noose, and he boots the ladder out. Imagine.
That visual is hilarious.
Oh, that is great.
As the ladder is pulled away, in her head, you could almost hear her go, oh.
He's trying to... No. Yes, he is. I'm choking.
How do you bargain with it while you're being hung? I thought once you were hung, you were dead quickly.
Yeah, that's why it doesn't sound right. Like, why the hell? How did she escape that if she's up on a ladder and he kicks the ladder out? Was the rope too long? What was this guy, an idiot?
Well, obviously, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or maybe he said, like, all right, here it is.
If you get somebody to climb a ladder and put their head in a noose, anybody with any sense is going to go, no, what if the ladder falls? So he might have said, I left the rope long enough that you actually land on the ground. It's going to make it look like I'm hanging someone, but your feet hit the ground. And then he kicks the ladder out, and her feet don't exactly hit the ground.
And then what he does is he takes all the haunted house stuff down, and he calls the police and says, my wife hung herself.
Well, we got a little more. We got the... This is how good our... We got the news story.
A haunted house turned to a house of horrors for us.
Horrors?
And now...
Horrors?
A house of horrors?
Wow.
A house of horrors.
No wonder he wanted her dead.
What a fun place.
He wanted to have fun with the whores.
Happy whore day.
A haunted house turned to a house of horrors for a Filipino woman, and now her soon-to-be ex-husband is facing attempted murder charges. KXY4's Jeff Humphrey is live at the courthouse, and Jeff, this was a suspect's alternative to divorce?
Yeah, the Sean Jennings' wife had told him that she wanted a divorce, but before she could file the paperwork here at the courthouse, police say Jennings tried to kill her.
This is the Jennings family garage, and this is the beam that Sean Jennings tied a noose onto. He then allegedly lured his wife here to the garage, and the guys are checking out a Halloween prop, then had her stand on this ladder. Once her head was inside that noose, Jennings allegedly pulled away the ladder, and then as his wife struggled for breath, he told her that he hoped that police would feel that she had committed suicide.
Ah, he's talking to her.
I know, like the end of a Columbo episode.
Yeah.
You see, I tricked you when I told you to climb the ladder, knowing the whole time I was going to remove it. one more question.
I can't imagine how she would hang herself. Why would she do that with all these, Halloween decorations around?
Fuck, Lieutenant, it's a simple question. She was depressed around this holiday season.
Halloween? All right, well, that fixes things, clears things up. Oh, one more thing. Why is your shoe scuff mark on the ladder?
Like, that's what he would find.
Yeah, just
a shoe scuff mark.
Sure.
I was trying to help her. I found her in the throes of death, and I tried... All right, you win, Columbo. Damn you, I killed her. There was fess up to it at the end.
You win again, even though supposedly I've never heard of you because this is my first murder attempt.
Yeah, good point.
I don't know how I know who you are unless I watch you on television.
They always confess to the dumbest piece of evidence, too.
I found a contact lens in the trunk of the car.
Oh, you got me. Holy jeez, I tried to kill her and stuff.
No, it's my lens. I just found it. I was saying that.
Mom, you got me. Lieutenant, you are a genius. Oh, you did it? I thought it was the other guy.
You ever see the one where there's a dead body in the wall with the pager, and Columbo calls the number,
and it
beeps from behind the wall, and the guy's like, ah, you caught me.
Just puts his head down instead of going, what the hell is that?
Yeah. Ah, you got me. More to the story here.
And I said, why are you doing this? What wrong? And he said, because this is easier to... It's easier for me to... kill you then go through the divorce.
However, police say Sean Jennings, seen here in court, then
I think there's a few guys out there that,
So that, was that her?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. She sounds like her voice is a little scratchy.
Yours would be a little scratchy, too, if you were hanging.
Her larynx has been crushed by her own weight.
Right. Just lost a little air there. Give her a break, will you? I think there's a few people out there going, I understand.
She's got to walk around like Tuco from The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly with that noose mark around her neck. You kill it, if you miss, you better miss really good.
Or at the end, actually what happened was Clint Eastwood fired and shot her down.
Yeah,
that's how she lived.
That's how it happened.
She fell on some gold.
You didn't go through the divorce.
However, police say Sean Jennings, seen here in court, then lowered his wife to the ground after she promised not to tell anyone about what he had done. And she remained silent until yesterday when she phoned police from this Walmart. Today, a judge set Jennings' bail at $500,000.
And if somehow Jennings can raise that amount of money today, Judge Peterson also ordered Jennings to stay at least two blocks away from his wife. Tonight, he's on a suicide watch inside the Spokane County Jail.
Two blocks away.
Could
Could you just put your head in the noose on that lamppost? No, I can't get any closer. Just do it, dummy.
Two blocks. Should be further than that. Guy trying to hang her. Wow.
All right, well.
Thank God she promised. Oh,
no, you first.
I was saying, thank God she promised not to tell. Imagine if she'd been stubborn or somebody that I would eventually wind up dating. Just promise you won't divorce me. I'm not promising anything.
Nothing. Just let me down.
Let me down so I can take half your money and call the police immediately.
That's probably the first in a, even though it was intentional, the first in the long line every Halloween season of people hanging themselves. Thinking they could be clever, make a little prop, scare people. If you put a noose around your neck and lower yourself down, you're going to die. Here's our public service announcement. Because every year some dopey kid hangs himself in a tree at a haunted little scenario that they set up for the kids.
Do they really?
Yeah.
But you guys used to hang yourselves from the stage during one of your rot gut performances.
Yes, we did. We
knew how to do it the right way.
When the curtain would open, the entire band, except for the drummer, it would be a little rough, but guitar, bass, singer, we were all hanging from the neck. And the curtain would open, and we'd be about 3 feet above the stage, hanging, just swinging. And we'd do a whole song like that.
How many drugs were you on back in the day?
All the people loved it.
You didn't have the right people working for you and the right roadies that could figure that stuff out.
Oh, I did everything. All the special effects.
Some S crap club on Long Island is going to figure out how to hang a whole band and no one's going to get hurt?
Here's how you did it. It was, and I don't suggest you doing this at home, even though it's pretty foolproof. There's no way you're going to hang yourself because there's not an actual noose around your neck connected to a beam or anything. We'd find the beams on the stage, and you get a rope, you tie it to the beam, and hang it all the way down. You make a giant loop of which you stand on. Your heels are, the soles of your feet are in the noose. So now you're hanging in a giant noose, and then you put on a painter's coverall. The paper ones, and zip it up. Now you got the thing coming out the back of the neck of the painter's suit. Then you take a piece of rope, not attached to anything, with some Velcro on it, and put it around your neck. So now it looks like the noose around your neck is connected to the rope that's going to the beam, but they're actually never even connected. So if you fell or anything, you would just sit there with a piece of rope around your neck.
And how high off the ground were you guys?
We were about 3 feet off the ground.
Ozzy used to hang a midget in his app. That's probably how he did it, too. It's like a waist harness or something like that. When the romance would play, the midget would be hung in a spotlight.
I wish he would just hang a midget. He'd have a new midget because they all look the same. Oh, he would just kill a midget, throw him out in the dumpster, and buy a new one the next day.
What are the cops going to do? Did you see a midget? What did he look like? About yay big, large head.
A flat Frankenstein hairdo. Stupid midget haircut.
They really do have the worst dues. Just buy little square hats for yourselves. Cut the malarkey.
Hitler's globe is going up for auction.
Hitler's globe.
Yeah.
Do they have an estimate on what they're going to think he's going to get?
No, let's find out here.
Well, you probably didn't know it, but a very rare piece of World War II history has been sitting in Oakland for several decades now. It is hitting the auction block. And as Alan Martin shows us, the winning bidder will literally own Adolf Hitler's view of the world.
Deutschland ist nun erwacht.
No one would argue Hitler
saw... Can I please say, this is the beauty of the news and how they languish in redundancy. Does anybody need to be brought up to speed on who Hitler was? Do they have to assault every bit of your senses by showing you a Hitler clip? Is there anybody going, who? Hitler? Huh? Who is this guy?
Well, we'll show you who this guy is.
Oh,
some stock footage of Hitler, right?
Of course.
You need it.
Of course you don't need it.
No one would argue Hitler saw the world differently. But right after Hitler's world came crashing down, his mountain retreat called the Eagle's Nest was bombed, and the Führer's personal globe was rescued from the rubble.
And then here's this globe, right on the table.
nobody's there, nobody, whatever.
91-year-old John Barsamian was the man who grabbed it. For 62 years, the globe has been in John's house in Oakland. He showed it to close friends, and his family knew the story. Now the world's hearing the details as the globe goes up for auction. John says he thought about giving it to a museum, but not being a millionaire, quite frankly, he wants some money for it.
Money is not, I mean this seriously, it's not that important, but sometimes you need it to pay some of the bills.
And a collector will get a view of the world some would consider priceless.
Well, the auction for that globe begins November 13th in San Francisco. The globe is expected to fetch somewhere between $15,000 and $20,000.
I'm in. I am in. I want Hitler's globe.
Well, how do we make that happen?
I don't know.
Find out how you bid on
it. How do I bid on it? That would be great. That would look great in my office.
It would just be one big, like, the whole thing is probably redone just so it all says Germany.
Yeah, just like everything scratched out.
Yeah.
United States of Germany.
Yeah.
Great Germany.
Big X's. Afro-Germany. That idiot.
Afro-Germany.
Well, Germanica.
So you're going to bid on that?
I would bid on that in a second. 15 or 20 grand?
Probably
for Hitler's
go for a lot
globe?
More than that.
Yeah, I know, but I'll see where I could what I could get. Maybe I could get 25. I'd pay up to $50,000 for Hitler's globe.
What?
It was taken right out of his
then what?
His
you have this thing, and then what?
I put it in my office.
But no one's ever going to see it, except you.
Exactly.
And his girlfriend, when she walks in at 3 in the morning, and he's nude, staring at it, with the moonlight hitting his face, mumbling. She'd be like, Anthony, your lips are moving. She'd be like, oh, I'm just talking to myself.
Spinning the globe.
Yeah, spinning it slowly. It's, like, that's, she'd be upstairs, and she'd hear,
what could have been?
All right, well, how do you bid?
I bid on Hitler's globe?
I'm sure somebody out there will help you out.
How come they don't, by the way, do that for other stuff? Like, they have the Hitler, and they have to show stock. Like, how about a rape was reported, and they show stock rape footage?
Yeah, it's really a crime. It's like a huge crime was committed on the entire world, and now they just auction his stuff off.
But they show him in the background. Like, you wouldn't be quite sure.
Yeah, Hitler, do they mean...
Was it Adolf Hitler?
Is it Adolf Hitler, or is it...
Was it Pete Hitler, the guy from Schenectady, who I had that run-in with?
Yeah, because I know he had a globe. I remember seeing it when I lived across the street from him. Might be his.
Who's that?
Oh, they're playing the footage. Okay. They mean World War II Hitler guy.
Well, when they describe 9/11, how these obsessive compulsive ninnies still feel it's necessary to go, when the nation was attacked by Islamic terrorists, we know.
Yeah.
Who doesn't know what happened?
Yeah.
And if you don't know by now, you don't care anyway.
Yeah, you're a fool.
You just don't care.
Or hey, you're one and you can't read the paper yet.
Did we find that story about the lady that got crushed? We got to do that before we get out of here. I don't have it in front of me.
It's right here, my sweet.
All right. What's the deal?
Woman spying on husband gets trapped under SUV. This is in Pittsburgh, where we used to be on and we are no longer. Rescue crews freed a woman trapped under a sports utility vehicle. She said that she thought her husband was cheating on her, so she went to spy on him, and by crawling under an SUV outside of his alleged girlfriend's house.
Mm.
This is the beauty of it. She apparently fell asleep under the vehicle and became trapped after someone let the air out of the tires.
How beautiful
is that? Like, not only are you spying to see if he's having sex, you doze. How tired are you when you doze off under an SUV?
How do you find that?
And then you can't hear.
Right.
You're sleeping.
How do you find that boring?
Exactly.
You're spying on your guy. He's with his chick.
She must be.
You're married
late.
To the guy, and you're bored to tears where you're going to fall asleep under an SUV as you're spying on him.
And then you don't feel it slowly being lowered onto you, one tire, unless they had four friends all simultaneously laying the air on the tires.
Yeah.
You had to go left rear, right rear, left front.
One tire at a time.
You don't feel it caving your chest in?
Little pressure.
Oh, God, is she wonderful.
Did she die?
No.
Unfortunately.
No, they got her out. I'm not sure if she was being crushed by it as much as once the air was out of the tires, she couldn't get out from under it. Like, she was trapped underneath it. I'm thinking
the husband or the girlfriend or something saw her, was onto it. Someone might have called, said, hey, you know, there's some woman underneath a SUV in front of your house. And then they went to look, realized she's asleep, have a little giggle, and then go, what can we do? Wouldn't it be great if we could just take the tires off of this thing and let it drop on her?
Probably not even that. They just want to trap her underneath the vehicle.
No, but at first the conversation is it would be great to just pull the tires off and let it crush her. And then you think, why don't we just take the air out of the tires and trap her under there?
Yeah, they're not looking at
scream.
They're not looking at criminal charges for the people that let the air out. The couple has been married for 26 years. The woman who was under the SUV was taken into custody to undergo a mental health evaluation. Nothing about the people that might have let the air out of the tire. So
no.
They probably decided, you know what, she's a kook. She's doing some crazy things. We got her now. Why don't we trap her and then call the authorities? All right, here's what happened in New Delhi with the monkey.
The inconsolable family of Delhi's deputy mayor, S.S. Bajwa.
Hello, Dell Customer Service? Hello? Hello? Dell Customer Service? Oh, sorry. Oh, I thought it was a personal call. I'm sorry. I really thought I was trying to get Dell Customer Service.
It's either Dell Customer Service or a mayor. We don't know.
Solvable family of Delhi's deputy mayor, S.S. Bajwa. Bajwa was attacked by monkeys on Saturday while he was...
Peter Tork?
Should anyone...
Did Peter Tork get him?
Should anyone in a civilized, like, city... Although New Delhi, I know, but I mean, should anyone be being attacked by monkeys unless you're in the middle of the rainforest?
No.
Seriously.
Jane Seymour never even got attacked by monkeys, and she lived with them.
F Jane Seymour.
Hey.
Oh, I meant
turning my mom down for a picture.
You got me. I'm tired. I meant to say Jane Goodall.
Oh, all right.
I was wondering why. Now you got me mad about Jane Seymour again.
Why else would I say her unless she was brought up today?
Jane Goodall.
I screwed up.
Dr. Quinn, monkey woman.
How great would that be? She gets a good savaging from a silverback with her stupid khakis on the set. Rips her little khaki trousers down. Your show sucks.
So the mayor apparently got attacked by monkeys.
Yeah. I just love the news reporter. Okay. I got to hear that again.
The family of Delhi's deputy mayor, S.S. Bajwa. Bajwa was attacked by monkeys on Saturday while he was standing in the balcony of his house. But he
balcony
lost
of the balcony house.
And they want a global community.
You would assume in the balcony of your house, you're safe from monkeys.
How are we ever going to have a global community? Really?
Wouldn't you see them coming? Oh, he's like Scarface. He was like shooting at all the ones in the steps, and then one big monkey shot him from the back.
Didn't see that monkey with the sunglasses on, the shotgun.
How 80s was that?
Oh.
Sunglasses on an assassination hit.
We get it.
Bajwa was attacked by monkeys on Saturday while he was standing in the balcony of his house, but he lost control and fell on the ground. Bajwa succumbed to his injuries today. Bajwa's death has once again brought the monkey conflict into focus. Throughout the capital, stray monkeys have spared none. Children are soft targets. The MCD has now hired monkey catchers to rid Delhi of the menace.
I didn't know he died from the monkey attack.
Yes.
I just thought he got attacked by monkeys.
No.
Everybody was fine, and it was kind of a cute, funny story.
No, he died.
He fell off the balcony?
Yeah. He was on his balcony. Monkeys attacked him on his balcony, and then he died.
So he's trying to fight off the monkeys, and he fell off the balcony.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
You gotta think.
That's horrible.
You gotta think monkeys in New Delhi, though, are like rats.
Yeah.
I hear like kangaroos are like rats to the Aussies.
Nah, I hear most Aussies never see kangaroos.
I hear like, but like we think kangaroos are cool, but to them it's like they're just a nuisance and they're like rats to us here in New York City.
It would be like.
And I hear the monkeys are the same thing in a lot of these countries. They're just like little just rats to them.
We just get cats and dogs, like stray cats and stray dogs around here. Nothing like the monkey.
How many were attacking him?
That must have been a few. Oh, would that have looked great? Sorry that he's dead and all, but boy, to see him on the balcony fighting off monkeys and then just tumbling over the railing.
You think as you fall to your death with monkeys on you, you're thinking, I'm the mayor.
I'm the mayor, damn it.
I'm the mayor of this city, and I'm falling with monkeys on me.
And you know those just damn super simians just got up and ran away after they fell the same distance the mayor did.
Yeah.
They fall off the balcony. They just brush it off like nothing.
They got springy things in their ankles.
Yeah, they could hit the ground. It doesn't matter.
They're not breaking their ankle getting out of a car. Ever.
No. Jill, our little monkey.
They can step out a window from 10 stories up. They're not breaking their ankle because they got those springy things in
there. Yeah.
They just make a monkey noise and run. Some loud, stupid monkey. Monkeys just sound dumb. It's like, all right, we get it. You're here.
Yeah, they do that. And then run off.
Why would they be on the balcony?
Leaving a dead mayor.
I don't get it.
He probably was out there eating something. Like, just, like, opens his... I picture a wrought iron balcony. I picture this guy opening up some French doors. The curtains are a white gauzy material and they blow out a little bit. And he's got some coffee and maybe a little Danish. And he's just breathing in the air and thinking, I'm mayor. Monkeys! And they just swoop in on him and grab him. And he punches one, but another one's trying to grab his Danish. He drops the Danish, and now, like, five monkeys are on him, and he's swinging, and he loses his orientation and flips backwards over the railing and just, bam, hits the ground dead. And the monkey runs off with his coffee and Danish.
And that's it.
And that's it. Dead.
Dead, I say.
How do you get them off you?
You don't.
It's not like bees where you can put water on you.
Bees?
Like, if there's bees, I always know if bees attacked me, I would run into the shower. I would turn the shower on real quick and stand there and get the bees watching.
Are you getting in the house? You're going into the house with bees on you?
I'm assuming I'm in the house when they attack me.
Bees are just... A swarm of bees, probably the most frightening thing to me.
Yeah.
I am petrified because you can't fight them off.
What about a pack of monkeys?
Pack of monkeys could be a problem.
Yeah.
Depending on how many and if you're on a balcony.
What about piranha?
Piranha, you're in the water.
Yeah, they're 2 feet
Once
away.
You're in the water, all bets are off. You can't be afraid of things in the water and go in the water. So if there's piranha, if you're in the Amazon and you're swimming and piranha get you, it's your goddamn problem. Bees, though, there was a guy who just opened his garage door and bees attacked him. He was covered head to toe in bees, stung him to death.
Right.
He was in a walker. Hey,
and what do you do? When bees attack you, there's nothing you can do. You can't roll on the ground like fire. You can't brush them off of you.
Can I do a service for everybody that might be going down to Atlantis in the Bahamas?
Oh.
You've been down there recently, right?
Yes.
And you know that I've said it before, but I got to say it again, that man-made lagoon they have?
Uh-huh.
Man-made lagoon right in front of the place. It's beautiful. And you can get a little snorkel, a little flippers. And
yep.
You can spend an hour in there. And it's pretty deep. The water's like 25 feet deep, and it's crystal clear.
There's fishies in there.
And I think they put a lot of the fish in there, and then it's attached to the ocean, so some other things will go in there. And it's just a lovely time, right?
Yeah.
They have these little yellow effers. They're no bigger than how big am I going here?
That's pretty big.
Silver dollar.
Like bigger. A big silver dollar. And they are really good to look at, very yellow, very bright, very vibrant.
Mm-hmm.
They travel in little packs, little pods
little
of them.
Schools.
Those
are they fishies?
Those effers will bite the crap out of you.
Yeah.
And they're not scared of you.
I hate that.
So then you spend half your time avoiding the cute little yellow fish down there. And they just nip, 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 nip at your body. Leaving little scars all over the place.
Fish suck.
Fish suck, Jimmy.
I hate fish. They're great when they're being slaughtered for your dining pleasure.
Made into cat food.
By the way, Jimmy, fish can't suck.
Sure they can. The mouths are always doing that sucking thing. How do you resist?
But you can't look. See, look. Make a fish thing.
It's true. It's like watching a burn victim try to suck something.
How do you suck if your lips look like this?
Here's the thing with fish.
Oh, boy.
I go to a massage parlor, and they have a small fish tank, and they have, like, 10 giant fish in it, and it's just the most uncomfortable thing I've ever seen in my life.
Why?
Because they're just the worst. It's like, do you people, I mean... There's giant fish in this little tank, and the fish are miserable. They're literally just, like, looking around, like, what do we do? They're bumping into each other. It's horrendous.
Overcrowding.
Yeah.
Big, dumb fish. They swim, like, 6 inches and stop, and they go, all right, I'm here.
Here. Waiting all day to get over there. It's been crowded.
You've never done any scuba diving or any of that crap.
No.
Snorkeling, no, nothing like that.
When you get away from, like, the reefs and stuff, and you just see these fish in the middle of nowhere, you think, wow, their lives just suck.
They're just food for something else.
There's nothing to see.
Hasn't eaten them yet.
There's nowhere to go. They're just constantly swimming. They can barely rest ever. Like, their lives have got to just suck.
The creepiest thing about snorkeling or scuba diving is when you reach an area that isn't a reef and it's just flat and you look off into the distance and it just goes into that haze of you can't see anything and you're just waiting for some monster to come out of there.
And you know your eyesight is looking pretty much hundreds, if not thousands of miles into nothingness.
Into nothing.
And you know there's big whales and
monsters in the water.
And stuff we haven't even discovered yet. Just just on the other side of that darkness.
Yep. Ugh. Too Dude, creepy down there. Got to bring your own air with you. I'm going to bring my own air.
We should have done this yesterday for Pot Talk Monday, but when I go up to Rochester, I go across the Great Lakes to Canada with Brother Weeze, and we'll stop in the middle of the lake and jump in.
And the boat, no, you won't.
And the boat's just floating, and... I don't know, maybe someone, you know, could help me out, but I think it drops down close to a mile or a good, whatever. After 12 feet, doesn't really matter. I love people go, it drops down 50 feet here. Really? Anything over, I'm just under 6 foot. Anything over 6 foot is pretty bad for me.
It might as well be 1,000 feet.
Maybe not. Maybe I could go 7 feet because I think you could bop up and down a few times.
Yeah.
Keep bopping off the floor.
Well, you don't want to touch the bottom, though.
Yeah, true.
Joe, but creepy.
But anyway, this is
kind of air.
This is kind of pot talk crap. But we would jump in the middle after some wine, going back to Rochester after being in Canada, whatever. We stop right in the middle of the lake, and it drops straight down. You can't see crap. It is as dark as can be, right? And I just picture like Weeze would just go head first and just dive in. And I'm like, how creepy is that diving in knowing it drops, who knows, a ridiculous, you know, thousands of feet?
Yeah.
And I just picture, because I'm too scared to open my eyes, so I just, like, jump in quickly. And I just picture if I open my eyes, there would be this just massive, now I know it's like fresh water, but just be, you know, bear with me, something the equivalent of a whale, like a foot away from me.
Yeah, if you open your eyes, that second, it'll be right there.
And then you get that thought in your head as you're jumping in, and it's horrifying. It brings you back to being like...
panicky.
Like 8 years old and realizing you're going to die someday. It is horrifying. Because that's all I can picture. If I open my eyes, there's just going to be this massive, like, Loch Ness monster thing.
I'm on the brink of panic whenever I'm in the water. Not a pool. I mean, pools are fine. But a lake or the ocean. And more so a lake, for some reason, more so a lake than the ocean. Like, the ocean's kind of moving around. You're by the shore. You kind of, you know, stay in that area. Everyone's there. You're body surfing or something. Well, but a lake is dark and murky.
And when you're in the ocean stuff, you got an exit strategy. You see where the shore is. Like,
yeah.
Like a lake, to really enjoy a lake, you got to kind of get out there. A pond, you kind of got to get out there.
Swim to the platform.
Right.
No. Oh, it's just so creepy. I don't know. I'm not a water person. Don't like it.
I just want to see if E-Rock has any more Jaws music for freshwater pond stories.
Freshwater pond. Yes.
Well, hold on.
Everything but sharks. He's got Jaws. So I was attacked by a flying thing. Dun dun
dun dun dun dun dun. I was in a car accident. Dun 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 dun.
Anything with what was raining. Jaws music. Quickly, kill it. Anything where water is mentioned.
Hey, this story made us laugh really, really hard in the office. And it's a tough day for us to be laughing.
But
this one definitely made us laugh. Listen to this dummy.
Well, prosecutors are asking the public for help in their investigation against a Manhattan child therapist caught with porn on his computer. Dr. James Bond.
All right, porn on his computer. Child psychologist, yeah.
That's right.
Oh, boy.
That's not what made us laugh, obviously.
That's probably not, by the way, that's probably not, I'm gonna guess. I've not heard this story, but I'm going to guess that's not the whole story, because that's not really bad.
WISPsucks.com. Interesting.
Yes. And after, by the way, after that last awful point I just made, I now understand why they took us off the air. Jokes like that.
This is where it gets exciting and fun. We live for this crap. Secretly, we live for this crap. No, Jimmy, there's more to the story. Was it a child psychologist working with kids? Child porn on his computer. What would make you laugh? Seriously, think it out, though, Jimmy. Seriously.
If there were photos of him having sex with me in 1970.
Would get a chuckle.
The irony would be like, wow, I don't remember you.
No, wait till you hear this one.
On his computer, Dr. James Bonsack was arrested Thursday after a maintenance worker found pornographic pictures of young boys on his screensaver. Bonsack
Wow.
Oops. Exactly.
You know, maybe.
Dude, we didn't even hear the rest of the story. We just started howling in the office. Howling.
On his screensaver.
On his screensaver.
Set to go into screensave mode every 30 seconds.
Right.
Gotta save this screen.
That's a rookie mistake.
How frothed up are you that you have to have it right on your screensaver?
On your screensaver. And you know, your screensaver is meant to save your screen, so it had to move around a little bit. Was it just some awful kiddie porn going from corner to corner of his screen?
Yeah, just bouncing from border to border.
I guarantee you what happened was this dummy. Like, I did the same thing Opie did. I stole an idea, which was, like, I never had my screensaver be my photos. Mm-hmm. I was at his place, and his screensaver is pictures of, his photos. So I set my computer to do that, and I guarantee this guy didn't realize that it was going through his whole library of photos.
Yeah, like slideshow.
He didn't know how it worked.
So it just, popped up.
Bonsack was arrested Thursday after a maintenance worker found pornographic pictures of young boys on his screensaver. Oh, Bonsack actually lost his job as a school social worker in 1996 after former students accused him of misconduct.
How amazing is that, though? On your screensaver. What's wrong with the Apple?
Nothing at all. It's actually, Renee just brought me an Apple. But the bottom line is, it's tapering. The Apple is wide on top and very narrow on the bottom. It looks like my Apple has jaw cancer. You ever see somebody after their jaw's taken off and they're talking into a spit bag?
They just look silly.
They really do. Just don't talk. Write it down.
This is a new segment we're trying out. All the stuff we didn't get to, it's called. Because some of the stuff is really good, usually.
It's called O&A's Leftovers.
Leftovers. Ugh. Backseat toilet to end mishaps and traffic jams.
Ah. Now, here's something we can use.
If you're stuck in traffic when Mother Nature calls, of course it's Japan. Of course it is. Japan's Kaneko Sangayawaka company has developed a loo for you. The manufacturer of plastic car accessories drew back the curtain on Tuesday on its new portable toilet for cars.
What the fuck? Who?
The toilet comes with a curtain large enough to conceal users and plastic bag to collect waste. Yuck.
The plastic bag is actually a woman in a fucking bridal outfit, and it comes with a video camera to put it up on YouTube when you're finished. Lovely culture.
The commode will come in handy during major disasters such as earthquakes or when you are caught in a traffic jam. If you're caught in an earthquake, who gives a shit where you shit?
Yeah.
You have bigger problems on your hand.
Exactly. You'd probably fall off the bowl anyway with the whole planet rumbling. Shit all over your front seat.
And here is some audio of someone actually using the toilet. Or not.
The fox. Try again.
Or, there we go.
That should have been audio.
You know the Japanese will probably use that in one of their game shows. Some host, some smarmy Japanese host will come over with a microphone and will quiet. And then rip the door open while someone's taking a dump. He'll laugh. They're just cruel to each other.
And in the funny toilet, they've put like a fucking an M80. He's gonna blow some guy's fucking smooth hairless bag off.
His fucking balls are on the headliner of the car, and they're just laughing at him.
Exactly.
Those Japanese don't care what they do to each other.
His fucking groin, it looks like a mouth that's been hit with a baseball bat. Just a big bloody gaping fucking area.
And
little balls have been blown off.
They're just hitting. They're just stuck to the fucking headliner like Tyson gave him an uppercut.
And the guy's like writhing in pain, holding his balls. But when he sees the hidden camera, he's like, oh, and he laughs.
You. It's.
Us?
Us.
Us.
Jesus.
Motto of your lotions.
The fuck is this?
What's he doing to the guy?
You want to know?
Yes.
All right. Japanese man tries to learn English while classroom full of other Japanese people try to remain quiet. If they laugh, they are caned on their asses. They are sick fucks.
What the fuck?
Is it a game show?
I don't even know how they get away with this
shit.
Yeah.
It's so funny.
How about this one?
Nation.
How about this one? Oh, my God.
I know what that is.
I can't get enough of this, man. The more you can find, Danny, the better for the show.
Dude, that one was violent.
What was that? What do you think that was?
I actually know what that was.
All right, Jimmy. Oh.
That was, there was a pregnant woman in a sushi restaurant, and she ordered a California roll. So instead, they had a ram come out and fucking hit her in the stomach with his horns.
You are correct.
It's called Stew the Tomato.
Okay, I gotta know what the fuck that was.
Women stare at a huge magic eye on a wall, right?
You know those magic eye books and posters? Well, picture a whole wall that just looks like a magic eye.
Oh.
And there are these maybe four or five women, and they're staring at it, trying to see the pattern turn into something. When...
Go ahead.
When a guy dressed in a spandex suit with the magic eye pattern on the spandex suit jumps out of the obviously false wall and scares the shit out of these Japanese women. And one of them, the one that screams, is actually screaming as she's passing out. And she's just out on the floor. And that's why they play that little ambulance. The first time I saw that, I think me and Thad watched it probably 50 times. It was just too funny.
I'm going to have to see that one.
The best part is they went through the trouble of making his outfit match the wall he was jumping through, but like, it's just scary to have a guy jump.
Could have been in a suit.
The pattern,
but the thousandth of a second where they realize it matches the wall he's coming out of is completely irrelevant, but they took the time to make sure he matched the wall he was jumping out of.
I just don't get them.
Yeah.
They're great.
Some dude in Syracuse, if you caught an earthquake, you don't need a toilet, you need new underwear. Good point. Mm. And then someone's trying to guess the sound. Well, Kevin from Connecticut, a faithful listener, he writes, that was a Japanese radio show angry about losing the Kobe affiliate. We have one more today. Holy shit, Jason C. from Georgia.
Wow.
The stupidest. You get the award of being the stupidest listener today.
Wow, good for you.
Jason C. from Georgia, he writes, fuck, do a TV show already. And then he continues, he goes, this is why you're not on in Philly, barely describing anything. The whole bit is not to describe this, you idiot. Let your imagination run wild, and then you tell everybody what it is.
Oh my God, you're an idiot.
You are the stupidest listener today. October 24, 2007.
Congrats. What's the name?
Jason C. from Georgia.
Congrats.
A dummy.
Jesus.
That is so annoying. How long does this go on?
No longer.
Oh my God. Sounds like people's shadows being burnt into building walls.
Exactly. What the fuck is it?
Almost over.
Probably a guy with a Godzilla costume just walked into a place freaking out.
See, the clip has to be that long because when you find out what it is, it just makes it that much better.
Ah, I've seen this video, by the way. This is probably one of the only ones I've ever seen as far as these Japanese game shows go.
As far as I'm concerned, this is probably one of the best ones I've ever seen. As far as creativity goes,
yeah,
it's the best. I mean, you want me to
yeah, go ahead.
Oh, please.
It's picture a platform, a raised platform with holes in it. And around, there's like a fiberglass wall that surrounds the entire thing.
Mm-hmm.
And through these holes on this bottom platform, Japanese girls poke their heads through wearing like meat headbands.
They look like steak doctors.
Yeah, like surgeons, but instead of that metal thing, it's like a piece of steak.
Right.
And then they let what I can only describe as a Komodo dragon loose. And the Japanese woman, the last Japanese woman to leave her head in this cage wins. Because the minute this Komodo dragon starts running for them, they all, you know, duck out of
they
the way
freak
and
out.
Run away.
Yeah. Whoa, yeah, I got to see that one, too.
It's fantastic.
It's the best thing ever.
Where did they... I don't know where they even think this up. We'll have Komodo dragon, meat hat, women.
A meat headband.
Who pitches these in fucking front of executives?
And they say yes.
Yeah.
Which ones didn't they take?
Exactly, where the one guy said they lay on their back with meat in their cunts and they can't run. And the winner is the last one, the Komodo dragon, actually pops his head through her stomach. She's the winner.
Tiny store clerk swings axe at robber. This is the dumbest story ever.
This is the video of the day on all the news shows. They're showing this one ad nauseum. Some little Turkish woman.
What?
Little Turkish woman.
And recently you were telling me that this is the type of videos you like watching on YouTube and Break.com.
Oh, absolutely.
All the other video sites.
Surveillance camera footage from convenience stores being robbed is just an all-day event. You could sit there at Break and just watch them. They're fascinating. Sometimes people get killed. Sometimes not. Sometimes the bad guy gets killed. Sometimes no one gets killed, but it's a great fight.
Yeah.
It's just entertaining. It's real-life crap. And this one, some Turkish woman defended herself against an armed gunman with an axe.
Yeah, let's follow this story closely, because this isn't going to play out well in the coming months.
No.
Because most of the time when, like, a clerk's in one of these situations and the news tries to interview them, they're like, no comment, no question. They don't want any attention on the fact that they just fended off a scary, scary robber.
Mm-hmm.
Because now the robber, I'm thinking, we'll get to the audio in a second here. Now the robber's friends are laughing at him.
Yeah, he's being mocked.
He's being mocked at a 90, I think she was less than 90 pounds.
85 pounds.
85-pound Turkish woman with an axe fended him off.
Not exactly the videotape you want to take back, like in Menace to Society.
Right, right, right.
You want to take that one back and show your buddies.
Yeah. Right. But here's the story. Oh, by the way, she's
a good one.
She's under 5 feet tall, too.
Yeah, she's like a progeria kid with an axe.
Yeah.
Stupid thing on her head.
She's officially a midget. I think midget starts at, 4'10", something like that. I think she's officially a midget.
She's little, and she's just a rail thin.
Right.
The surveillance video is really stunning. A tiny clerk right there defending her store from an armed robber by brandishing an axe. This happened on Long Island.
CBS 2's Jennifer McLogan spoke to the brave young woman about her frightening experience.
I grabbed it like...
She stands less than 5 feet and weighs only 90 pounds, but Hafize Sahin can wield an axe like Paul Bunyan.
I said, get out of here, please, get out of here. I don't want you here. I grabbed him axe, and then trying to hit him, and, you know, this is...
Did you fear for your life?
Yeah.
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 By the way, this is a perfect example why ONARadio.com rules. Stephen S. from Bayshore, he does the show rundown. Now, you got to see this video. This video will be up on that site later on today. Later on this morning, matter of fact. Because you got to see this tiny little thing with this really strange-looking axe, by the way. It looks like she brought the axe from...
her homeland from Turkey.
It's like I explained it as a witch's axe. It's bizarre looking.
It's like a shortened Grim Reaper little sickle. This is how it should have ended.
Get out of store. Leave me. Leave. Ah!
That's how it should have ended. They call her a brave woman. She's being stupid.
Well, yeah, we look at this stuff a little differently when you had the Subway Superman jumping on the tracks to save that guy and having the train run over him.
Yeah.
Everyone was praising him as a hero, and we weren't praising him. We were saying, this guy's stupid.
Yeah.
He's a dummy.
And this woman, stupid.
Stupid. Especially because she's talking to the press about what she did.
Yeah. Guy's going to come in there and go, you made me look the fool.
That's right.
Today at her workplace, friendly Quick Mart of Brookhaven on the Montauk Highway, with her dad and stepmom looking on, Havise demonstrated how, alone in the store, she protected herself from a robber who aimed a gun at her head and threatened to pull the trigger. Police say it was all caught on videotape.
He produces a handgun. As you see, he's pointing it directly at her head. They're demanding money. We think he's trying for either telephone there or to take money from her personally. This is where she removes the axe to defend herself. And you can see him pointing the gun at her, and she chases him out of the store.
She was just hysterical, you know, crying, but she beat the guy off. He was about 62.
She beat the guy off, huh?
Yeah,
apparently.
She was really upset.
Wow, man.
What was,
Doesn't seem like she was that upset if she beat the guy off.
That was the quote.
Yeah.
The funny thing is that I like the reference they used to Paul Bunyan.
Yeah.
Couldn't they have updated with the axe? He swings an axe like Jack Torrance.
Right. She could barely swing the axe. She could barely get it over her head. There was no real swinging of the axe going on.
It's like a long stick with a little teeny Hitler mustache blade on it.
And the gunman was quoted as saying, I couldn't believe when she brought out the ask.
I did try the best what I can do, you know.
Havise is a co-owner here, a new bride, recently married. She says she wants to have children and would not hesitate again to pick up that axe. Reporting from Brookhaven, Jennifer McLogan, CBS 2 News.
Well, police are still searching for the robber, and while they say Hafise was remarkably brave, they also say she was very lucky. They do not recommend putting up a fight against an armed robber.
There you go. Someone with some sense to them. And we recommend you never talk to the media about it and brag about how your tiny, tiny little body fended off a monster.
We're actually saying don't do anything this idiot from Turkey did.
Right.
What a dolt.
Really dumb.
Gun beats axe in a fight.
Every time.
Face to face. Gun beats axe. Don't make a maniac out of me.